Trev, we're done with NASCAR.
It's really good to have you back.
It really is.
Yeah. You see him walking around with his headphones blaring, alone in his own zone, cold, and he don't care. There's no control. He just lets his emotions go. Everybody just feels like they can relate. They can be great, or they can be great. Or even worse, they can teach hate. That's why we seize the moment, try to freeze it and own it, squeeze it and hold it, as we consider these minutes golden. And maybe they'll admit it when we're gone. Just let our spirits live on through our lyrics that you hear in our songs. And we can sing
a little Eminem on 8-track, courtesy Kevin Kennedy. 8-track? Today on Fox, it's been 111 years in the making, but well worth the wait. One of the best rivalries in sports could spell the end for Tony and Dusty's beautiful friendship. The subject of long-term relationships. They're dealing with that 85-year championship drought in Boston. And look at this. The new champs on the block have come to flaunt their rings. But can they regain that championship swing? We've got 137 days until the October magic begins, but who's counting, right? Welcome inside the Fox Network Center. Good to see us. It's Jeannie Zalasko, Kevin Kennedy, Fox Saturday Baseball, your game of the week. More importantly, it is opening day.
Yeah,
right?
that was not my hair in a picture.
It's opening day.
That was not my hair in a tabloid, by the way. Yes, it is opening day, and you know what? I'm going to talk about Kansas City Royals.
Please do.
You know,
are they for real?
40 games into the season, I always felt that's when you know if you're for real or not, whether you got to tweak your ball club. These guys are for real. They finally have gone to player development and scouting again, up through the minor league system. Guys like Chris George and Hernandez and their closer, McDougal, throws 101 miles an hour, and Tony Pena's done a great job. They are for real in a division that's not that strong this year.
All right, speaking of your hair, you got a little confetti up there. While you're doing that, in the Royals' glory days, you know, games would last 2 hours. Is it me, or are games shorter these days?
Games are shorter. The pace is picked up. You know who it's going to affect? Guys like Nomar Garciaparra. He's got all the things going on with the gloves. Every time a pitch is thrown, Nomar steps out. Look at 2002, the time it took, versus this year, 2003. Now, the pitcher has gone from throwing the ball 20 seconds in between pitches to now he has to throw the ball 12 seconds in between pitches. Nomar has to be quicker, and that's the guys that it affects. It affects his routine. He's done that all the way going back to high school days. We'll take a look at the time of the game. 252 versus 246. That's 6 minutes right there. 2003, six games under 2 hours completed in Major League Baseball all told this year. Three games already under 2 hours. And the point of this all is to pick up the pace of the game. It's not so much that the Major League Baseball is worried about 6 minutes. That's not going to make a difference for the family of four going to the game, leaving 6 minutes early.
Right.
More about the pace of the game for everybody involved.
I'll tell you what's making a difference. Check out the AL East standings. And the Red Sox, whose bullpen really took a beating coming into the season, they're improving. And now it's the Yankees in question marks.
By committee. Really, the committee is kind of over with. I think they've settled mostly on Brandon Lyon right now. He's done a pretty good job in that bullpen for them. ERA's in the low twos. The biggest disappointment for the Yankees so far has been their bullpen. Their overall pitching has been good, but the bullpen, Rivera just got back as a closer. They're not going to use him for six outs anymore. They can't afford to do that, get him hurt. They miss a guy like Jeff Nelson. That's been the big difference, I think, down there. Osuna's a guy that is capable of doing the job.
All right, let's talk about a giant change in the National League. Dusty in Chicago, and they're not like worried about it in San Francisco.
No, you know, Brian Sabian wanted one guy and one guy alone. It was Felipe Alou, 68 years old. I was his first bench coach back in Montreal in 1992, a great communicator, the wise old baseball man. Everybody looks up to this guy, commands great respect, and he can handle Barry Bonds, and they've retooled that ball club, and that's why they're playing so well.
And chances are the wise old man has seen 298 of Roger Clemens' victories. What about 299? Do I hear 299 on a Friday night with the Rangers in town?
Not with this guy. Hank Blaylock hitting 367, leading baseball in hitting. This guy has been absolutely outstanding this year, Jeannie.
All right, but here come the Yankees as we go bottom eight. It is Raul Mondesi with the RBI single. That evens the score at five apiece.
Mondesi swinging better this year. No question about that, playing a good right field. Here's the Yankees trying to win the ball game. Base hit to left field. Bernie Williams trying to come home. That's Donnie Sather playing a short left field for this very reason. That's why you play shallow.
Wages on the line. Top 12.
It's Blaylock again. As I said, 367 a year ago. They gave him a chance to have the job in the big leagues. Couldn't do it. He only hit 200, went down to the minor leagues, came back up, and he's leading the league in hitting right now.
Seven RBI in the night. The Cardinals have dominated the Cubs at Busch, 20-3 since the 2000 season.
Well, the big question, do we give up on J.D. Drew? That's been going on for a couple of years. You better not. This ball's hit over 500 feet, a bomb for the home run, and the Cardinals beat the Cubs again.
21-3 since the 2000 season. The National League reigning champion Giants.
Well, that's a 96-97 fastball you're trying to get out of the way of, and Mike Piazza pulls a groin muscle right there, and Vance Wilson would have to pick up for him because Piazza goes on the DL.
Vance Wilson would have to pick up for him, and that's what he did. Top seven with two outs. The RBI single would tie the score at 5 apiece.
And here's Edgardo Alfonso, a good pickup for David Bell. Not hitting so well so far this year, but he's getting that average up lately. He should be a 300 hitter. Had a big home run yesterday and a big run scoring single right there.
Nice to beat his former team. And we're in Los Angeles now. Marlins in town, and Sean Green swinging a hot bat.
Yeah, hot bat right here. Doubled into right center. Looked like Juan Pierre was going to make that play. Two base runners on. Maybe a dive would have helped. Didn't happen because you have to manage with a sense of urgency right here and play that way when you got Eric Gagne of the Dodgers coming in. It's lights out.
That's exactly what it was, Bob. Bottom line here with two out, bases empty. That door is slammed shut. But how about the Atlanta Braves?
They start out 4-8. These guys are absolutely phenomenal. The best outfield in baseball with Chipper in left, Andrew in center, Gary Sheffield in right having an MVP season. They got John Smoltz finishing it off. This guy's absolutely phenomenal as well.
All right, you could take a break, but you cannot take a break. You cannot take a break because all season long, Fox Sports and Sprint are going to be interactive. During each of today's games, you're going to have the chance to make your voice heard with Sprint Virtual Manager. Use your PCS Vision phone from Sprint or log on to foxsports.com to vote on questions pertaining to your particular game. Still ahead, school is back in session, and Professor Kennedy wants you to have your eraser handy because it is time to rewrite the record books. Get ready to witness history in 2003. Before we move forward, we look back at how the ring was won. Who can forget the Thunder Six? Who can forget the Monkees?
What begins as an endurance test becomes a question of survival. The Coca-Cola 600 next Sunday on Fox.
See you next week.
See you, Bill.
Good job, man.
Rusty, what's hurt?
Hey, I'm just trying to get home, man.
Introducing the Dodge SRT Series. Race inspired, street legal.
Sweet. For great storage ideas, head to Menards. Check out our great selection of pre-cut, ready-to-assemble wood storage sheds. The 8x8-foot Imperial has over 400 cubic feet of space. On sale, just $299. Keller fiberglass ladders won't split rot or conduct electricity. A 6-foot industrial-rated stepladder is on sale, just $69.95. A 24-foot extension ladder is $169. Menards is a step above the rest.
Save big money at Menards.
Introducing the new Nissan Murano for your adventures in on-roading.
Are on the best damn sports show, period.
Please welcome Samuel Jackson.
Weeknights on Fox Sports Net.
Next week, the countdown to the American Idol finale begins with three nights of music and excitement. Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, the television event of the season kicks off with your final two contestants. Be there Monday for a finale so big, it takes three nights. American Idol, starting Monday at 8, 7 Central on Fox.
Welcome back to the Budweiser pregame show, brought to you by Budweiser. Best things in life are the things that are true. Budweiser. Just when you thought it was safe to turn on the TV, they're back.
They're back. You see
memories or flashbacks?
They got a big ring this winter. I saw.
Definite flashbacks.
Oh, boy.
Too much monkey business. Hey, by the way, if the Angels are going to win another championship this season, get this monkey out of here, the first thing they have to do is forget about the last one. Forget the Yankees. Forget the Twins. Yes, Even forget the monkey. Not my rule. It's a Mike Socha edict.
Throw that at me.
So here's one final trip down memory lane.
I see skies of blue and clouds of white. The bright, blessed day. Dark sacred night.
Are these scenes that are fresh in your mind, or is this like watching an old home movie?
I've seen this footage a million times now, and it's pretty special, and it's something that I try to bring back to help me in today's game.
When I look back on our success last year, it was so gratifying because everybody was involved. It wasn't just a fluke here or there. I mean, it was whose night was it going to be, and we did that night after night.
How did it change your life when you guys travel, when you go into other stadiums now and several thousand people boo?
I've been personally booed in, you know, Seattle, Oakland and stuff, but I think that makes it sweeter because, you know, they actually know who we are and we've done something in the past.
I know that teams are gunning for us because we beat a lot of teams last year, but just to get to that level was incredible. We had to be on our game pretty much every day.
Sometimes having success is tougher than having adversity because there are a lot of expectations, and if you let that get in the way, it can become a problem.
Did you mention your manager doesn't want us even talking about 2002?
Right now, we've gone through some, you know, a couple bumps in the road already, and, you know, you can't live on or rely on last year's success to get you through this season. We got to continue to look ahead and, well, actually get back to playing one game at a time and get back to playing our kind of game. And that's really been our biggest challenge right now. It's just getting on track and worrying about ourselves right now.
Explain to me why you're asking your guys to not talk about 2002, please.
I think we've had our victory lap. We're moving forward. We're a good team, and we're looking for 03 to be a big year for us. And I think the only way that can happen is, hey, we already had our congrats for winning the World Championship. Let's move on.
Now you know what you have to do, you know what works, and you have to go out there and do it again, and that's called execution.
So what do you do for 2003 to get to the same point?
We're a scrappy team, we're an aggressive team, we're a team that's very capable of doing what we did last year.
The Angels, world champions!
I see trees of green.
Mike Socha takes nothing for granted. This year, the Angels are struggling a little bit early, but guess what? They're playing better ball the last 10. They've won 7 out of 10. They are now even at 500. A year ago at this time, they were 23-17. But remember, they had a 6-14 start a year ago. They're hovering around 5.5 games back. Runs per game down a little bit. ERA up a little bit. I think they really missed Darren Erstad. All the fill-in guys are doing a good job. There's no question about that. Bullpen is still number one overall in Major League Baseball. Starters have to pitch a little better. Don't worry about the Angels. I think they're going to be there at the end.
First championship for the Angels. Obviously, more history-making moments on tap for 2003. But I ask you, what's going to happen first? Mike Piazza get the record, or Mike Piazza get to first base?
Well, the record you're talking about, Jeannie, is behind the plate as a catcher. Carlton Fisk, as a catcher, has the all-time record at 351 for home runs. Mike is only 8 away from that. He's got to get healthy first either way, although eventually he will move to first base. Speaking of milestones, we've seen a lot already this year, and there's more to come.
The Babe Ruth founded fraternity, known as the 500 Club, welcomed 2 new members this season, and 2 more can do it if they stay healthy. The first to be welcomed was Slammin' Sammy Sosa in early April.
There it goes! Number 500! Sammy Sosa!
Over the years, Sosa has made massive technical changes in his swing to keep improving. He bulked up in muscle, learned to stay back, and used his legs tremendously to drive for power. Last Sunday, we saw Rafael Palmeiro enter the elite club.
He built it!
He's a player I personally managed and saw him make himself into the hitter he is. His self-made sweet swing began by spraying the ball to all fields, but now he launches him out to all fields at a very consistent rate. He is the only player in Major League history to hit 38 home runs or more in 8 straight seasons. Mr. Consistency, Fred McGriff, is only 16 home runs shy of entering the club. Over his 18 seasons in 6 different ball clubs, the swing, it always looks the same. He uses the lower half of his body extremely well to get those long arms through the ball. Ken Griffey Jr. was well on his way to the club until the injury bug got hold of him. He's been on the DL 4 times in the last 3 years and has just 31 home runs in 185 games. But he will get to the 500 mark. If not this season, then the next. The one pitcher hitting a big milestone mark this season is Roger Clemens. He will join only 20 others in Major League history to have 300 or more wins, and he's just too shy. Roger always understood that you have to be mentally strong and mechanically sound for longevity. He uses his legs so well that he has eliminated pressure on his throwing arm, and that has helped him stay healthy and consistent. I saw him as a 34-year-old throw his second 20-strikeout game versus the Tigers in 1996. He has not looked back, and he's still going strong. Health, consistency, longevity, but most of all, tremendous talent has helped these players do exactly what they have done. No matter what era we're talking about, these players would be great, and nothing should diminish their great accomplishments.
And I've heard people in and out of baseball try to diminish what 500 home runs is. There's only 19 guys so far in history that have done that, and they talk about the short porches today in Major League Baseball. How about specialists today in Major League Baseball for these guys? Go back to Mel Ott. How far was the Polo Grounds in the outfield? 257 down the line. How about Fulton County Stadium, Hank Aaron? That was a launching pad there. And Old Memorial Stadium where Frank Robinson played, that was a launching pad as well, only 300-plus down the lines.
All right, coming up next on Fox, we need to take you out to the ballgame, Kevin.
I'm pumped. I'm ready.
I can tell. It doesn't get much better than this. That's why he's pumped. Old rivals collide. Sure, for years, Cubs have been the punchline to a joke, but nobody's laughing now, especially not the Cardinals. And I'll see your monkey and raise your monster, a green one. It's going to be a good one in Boston. We'll keep you posted.
Extreme sports, all in one place. Weeknights on Fox Sports Net.
I'm sold. It's got to be the Explorer.
I agree. The smooth car-like ride and the great handling make me feel safer.
And look what I found. Explorer is the best pick by the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety.
No wonder it's the best-selling SUV in America.
And the most trusted.
You know, the others just didn't come close to Explorer's handling.
The only decision left is the 0 for 60, or Ford matches our down payment up to $1,000 for a total of $4,500 down.
Let's go pick it up and we can talk about it on the way.
If you haven't looked at Ford lately, look again. This family did.
Behind him is a 400-square-foot deluxe bachelor with a partial view. In front of him is a junior executive semi-private with no view. But right now, life is perfect. On the open road, in complete control of an Acura RSX. One of Car and Driver's 10 best.
Hello.
Jack.
When do they need me?
Now.
The past 23 hours have been filled with surprising twists.
Three countries colluded to explode a nuclear bomb on our soil, and we have proof.
But the biggest shock of them all still awaits.
You think you'll be safe out there?
Now, the series that rewrote the rules of television suspense.
You can't do this!
We'll break them again.
I don't have a choice. None of this was supposed to happen this way.
Whatever you do, don't miss the powerful season finale. 24 at 9, 8 Central, Fox Tuesday.
I'm Jeannie Zelasco back at the Fox Network Center. Dusty Baker's winning recipe has the Cubs tasting success. That's definitely something the Cardinals can't stomach. Old rivals, duke it out. Next on Fox. Leave it!
Budweiser presents the Fox Saturday Baseball Game of the Week from downtown St. Louis in the shadow of the brewery. We're at Busch Stadium. Great time to be here because the Cubs are in town. The Cubs and Cardinals, the first place Chicago Cubs. People will pack in here, fill these seats, and watch this battle. Game two of what is their four-game set. The Cardinals start the day three games out. And look at the Cubs, a game and a half in front of Houston. All right, where you been, huh? Where you been? The Fox Saturday Baseball Game of the Week is back. Where have we been? What have we been thinking? We've been thinking about this day to say welcome back to you and welcome back to Tim McCarver. Get over here.
All right.
Here we go. The Cardinals and the Cubs, and we're a month and a half into this season. We know a few things. The Cardinals know that they can hit. They know that they can catch the ball. The question is, do they have enough pitching to win the division again?
They lead the National League in batting average, a .291 average, and half of their eight position players received gold gloves before today's game for last year's excellence. They have adequate starting pitching, but once those starters leave the game, the bullpen takes over, and that is their Achilles heel.
In particular, the closer's role with Isringhausen down, and he may not be back before a month from now. On the other side, if the Cardinals' starting pitching is adequate, the Cubs' starting pitching is anything but. They can go 1-4, maybe 1-4.5, and shut you down every day they run one of these guys out there.
The Cubs can't hit with the Cardinals. They can't catch the ball with the Cardinals, but they can pitch with anybody. And the guy you're going to see today is very special. After only 27 starts in his major league career, his first full year as a major leaguer, 22-year-old Mark Pryor will go to the hill, and he is special.
As they would say in St. Louis, he's a horse.
Horse.
He's a horse.
He is indeed.
He's a horse. You can look through 100 years of this great rivalry. Tinkers, Evers, Chance, and some of the great names and faces. Even, it's going to be quick, that guy right there, McCarver. Cubs and Cardinals. How about that great September night when McGuire and Sosa got together a few years ago? Glad you're with us. Fox Saturday Baseball now.
Watching Fox Saturday Baseball Game of the Week.
Hi, folks. Peanut.
Can I get a bag of nuts, please?
Coming right up.
The Civic from Honda. It figures.
Hot dogs. Candy.
Now you can lease a 2003 Civic LX sedan for $159 a month for 48 months.
Want a no-nonsense pickup that works as hard as you? Grab the redesigned 2003 GMC Sierra work truck and get 0% APR for 60 months for qualified buyers. GMC Sierra, the only half-ton pickup on the road that's built to be professional grade. Starting at $16,115 after $3,000 cash back. Get into a new 2003 GMC Sierra work truck. See the pros at your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana GMC dealers.
Walks that way.
Thanks.
You're closer to a Volkswagen than you think. In fact, really, really close.
There is some rain in the area. Right now, it's a cool but pretty day in downtown St. Louis as Brett Tomko gets ready to take on the Chicago Cubs. And their starting lineup is brought to you by Budweiser. They will lead it off with Gresolonic, the second baseman. Alex Gonzalez fouled a ball off his foot last night. Question as to whether he would start, but they're a much better team with him in the lineup. Then O'Leary playing for the injured Sammy Sosa. Alou is off to a good start. Karras playing instead of Hesop Choi. Corey Patterson, Lenny Harris gets the start at third. Miller is the catcher. Pryor pitching and batting ninth. And here's the right-hander, Brett Tomko.
If Brett Tomko can forget two things, last Sunday, where he gave up 9 earned runs against the Cubs. Now, they were not official because that game was rained out after 4. And if he could skip the first inning has been woeful for Brett this year. 16 of 28 runs yielded in the first.
And so the Cubs go up there hacking. You don't think the Cubs don't know about that? Pitch count 1-15 for Brett Tomko. Opponents are hitting .591 against him. Gresolonic has been hot, cold, hot. Right now he is warm. And he takes a pitch down and in, a ball and a strike. We talked to Tony La Russa before the game about how you explain and then try to correct that problem right there. First inning mistakes and first inning messes, and one of them is, instead of trying to blow the ball by everybody, use all of your pitches and pitch like you might later in the ballgame.
That's right. Pitch the first inning like you might the fifth, sixth, and seventh inning if you get that far.
Base hit, left side, breaking ball, and Grisolanik is on to start the day for the Cubs. How about the defense for the Cardinals? Tim told you a moment ago that they just received four Gold Glove awards from Rawlings prior to today's game, and there's one of them. Jim Edmonds out in center. The other Gold Glove Award winners, Fernando Vina, Scott Rowland, and Edgar Renteria. And it's Vina and Renteria up the middle, as good as it gets on the double play combination. It's here in St. Louis. So one on with nobody out for Chicago. 7-4 St. Louis win last night in game one of this set. And Gonzalez takes a ball 0 and away. More than anybody, Tim, you would have to convince Tomko that, you know, here's a leadoff hit. You're dealing with the Cubs, and you have to guard against him thinking, here we go again.
Yeah, that's right.
Back toward us.
There have been many pitchers over the years that have had problems in the first inning. A lot of times, muscle-bound pitchers, guys who can't get loose. And I've asked Tony La Russa if he and Dave Duncan, the pitching coach, have gone to Bob Gibson. Yes, he was one that had trouble in the early innings. Tom Seaver, another. But I asked Tony if he had suggested to Tomko that he warm up a little earlier. He said no.
Anything really to try and break the routine, you would
sure
think, because these guys are so routine oriented.
Mm-hmm.
That you might just change it up a little, if nothing else, than to try to convince the pitcher that things are different.
Yeah, in a game habit oriented, it's dominated by starting pitchers.
Chris Widger is looking up at Gonzalez as Gonzalez strikes out. There's one out here in the first inning. Widger does the catching today. These two worked together when they were both in Seattle.
Good sinking fastball from Tomko. Usually that's a ball that's put in play. You don't see too many major league hitters swinging through a low fastball, but Gonzalez did then.
Troy O'Leary instead of Sammy Sosa. We showed you McGuire and Sosa leading to our first commercial break today, and Sosa's on the disabled list, having the toenail removed from the big toe on his right foot, his back foot, when he stands in a batter's box. And while he's only on the 15-day disabled list, we certainly got the idea from Dusty Baker that it's going to be much longer than that.
Yeah, you hear that term, for instance, rotator cuff, and you can't feel the pain. You hear the term toenail removed from the right big toe, you feel the pain.
I think we can all relate to how
yes
that must feel. Double play ball. I said they were one of the best. They don't disappoint. 6-4-3, and Tomko and the Cardinals breathe a sigh of relief. And now one of the best young, if not the best young, pitchers in the game heads to work. Mark Pryor, no score.
Have you ever spent like 5 minutes with him? He's totally self-centered and insensitive. They just don't go together. I mean, she's my best friend. She has these emotional needs he can't meet. Remember what she went through with Brad? It was just like awful. He's so rude.
And it's a deep drive to center. Rodriguez makes the catch. It looks like they're going to send the runner. Here comes a throw. He's safe. He's safe. The winning run is now on third.
You're such a great listener.
Thanks.
When you can get the best of wireless without a contract, that's M-Life. Go. Go phone. Only from AT&T Wireless.
Hey, Tom, I told this guy you make a great sandwich. Tell him.
Well, I start with a rich blend of savory Monterey and cheddar cheeses. Then add flavorful herbs like garlic, dash oregano, a pinch of rosemary.
Sounds like a great sandwich.
Sandwich? That was just the bread.
Great bread makes a delicious sandwich. That's why Subway has a line of gourmet breads like the tasty new Italian urban cheese. Fresh baked with garlic, oregano, rosemary, topped with Monterey Jack and cheddar cheeses.
Ready to hear more?
I think I'm ready to eat.
Subway!
The lights are on. You're not home. Budweiser is presenting this Fox Saturday Baseball Game of the Week from St. Louis. Overcast day. It's gray. There's a little wind. And there is a stud. 22 years old. He wears that number on his gut and on his back. Mark Pryor. And we'll take a look at the St. Louis Cardinals starting lineup brought to you by Budweiser. They will lead it off with Fernando Vina. J.D. Drew, a rare back-to-back start effort for J.D. Drew, who pounded a home run last night. Albert Pujols, Jim Edmonds, Scott Rowland batting fifth, Edgar Renteria leading the league in hitting, Tino Martinez, Chris Widger, and Brett Tomko, a good hitting pitcher, batting ninth. And there is Mark Pryor with the best ERA in the National League.
I am reminded of a quote by Jim Fry, the ex-manager slash general manager of the Cubs, who said about Doc Gooden, if I had his stuff, I would be poised on the mound too. Well, if a lot of guys had Mark Pryor's stuff, they would be poised, and he certainly is.
Of all of the attributes that Pryor has, I know one thing that gets your attention immediately is the look that he has in those eyes when he stares in at a hitter.
Oh, you have to love that look. A lot of confidence, competitiveness, great leg drive for a tall guy. He's 6'4", 230 pounds.
Facing the Cardinals for the second time. He faced them once last year, went five innings, allowed a couple of runs. And then the Cubs shut Mark Pryor down at the end of the season. He started the year at Double-A, went to Triple-A, and then made the final jump to the big leagues, and he won't be going back to the minor leagues outside of some sort of injury rehab, which the Cubs hope never happens. But they shut him down to try to avoid such situations, something they had to suffer through with Kerry Wood. The defense for Chicago, it is not a very good defense. 14th in the National League. They've already committed 35 errors compared to the Cardinals' 15. They have Gonzalez and Grzelcyk up the middle. Karros at first base today in place of Hee-Sop Choi. And J.D. Drew, who hit a 514-foot home run last night, bats with one out and takes a strike.
No surprise. We talked about the leg drive of Mark Pryor. You don't usually see that out of tall pitchers. He uses his big thighs, big rear end. Great action on his fastball in particular.
You look at the width of the body of Pryor, and
thick,
he and,
right.
And Tomko, both right-handers, but when you see Tomko on the mound, compare what you see to Pryor. Pryor is so well-built below the waist that he can use that great leg drive.
Mm-hmm.
And the Cubs hopes take some of the strain off his arm. He is a guy who will give you on average over 107 pitches per start as he misses high. A one ball two strike count on Drew. Clunker up the middle. Grzelcyk to his right. Two down.
That's what happens when you have that good a fastball. You gear up for the fastball, and then you get a breaking ball about 10 miles an hour slower, and you hit it off the end of the bat. It's very difficult to adjust to that breaking ball when you're confronted with a 96-mile-an-hour fastball.
Now it's Albert Pujols. With the bases empty and two down. Fastball poured in. For a strike. No balls, one strike. Pujols hitting 320. Nine home runs, 27 RBIs. Decent numbers, but he is a frustrated hitter, believe it or not. Very quick bat. There aren't many who can get the ball past Albert Pujols inside. Pryor's got as good a shot as anybody. With two out, nobody on. A bender in for strike two.
That was a great shot of that competitiveness that we were talking about of Mark Pryor, a knee buckler to Pujols.
Two and two. You look at the first two seasons for Albert Pujols, and they are staggering, the kind of numbers that he put up. 21-year-old first-year player two seasons ago. And hands down, rookie of the year. It's high and it's a full count with Edmonds on deck. Pujols' first year hit .329 with 37 home runs and 130 RBIs and backed that up last year with a .314 average, 34 home runs and 127 RBIs. Play third base, first base, the outfield, 3-2 pitch. We'll do it again.
You said Mark Pryor might be the only guy to get in on Pujols. He just got in on Pujols. A trademark foul ball by Albert.
You don't see a lot of pitchers muttering to themselves when they have two out, nobody on. But Pryor's doing it, trying to figure out a way to get Pujols, and I think he figured it out. Breaking ball to end the inning, and the Cardinals go 1-2-3, and we got an early glimpse at how good this right-hander is, and so did Pujols. After one, no score.
Hey, Mom. The rat, he looked at me, and then he started to sleep. And then the rat, he looked at me again.
I can't believe I'm getting this emotional over a rat.
Somehow I doubt it's the rat.
Introducing Picture Mail That Talks from Sprint. Share it when it happens.
A breakthrough offer from Midas. Right now, get lifetime brake pads or shoes for just $39.95. And you'll never have to buy brake pads or shoes again for as long as you own your car. Next stop, Midas. Lifetime brake pads or shoes, $39.95. Only at Midas.
Senseless garage door destruction. A problem no more thanks to the twice as fast accelerator. Only from Genie.
What are you doing, Bobby?
Making a reality show. Who wants to marry a Texan?
But he's already married.
Shh, we don't reveal that until the last episode.
Well, why are you filming him changing his Autolite double platinum plugs?
He always says nothing outperforms the platinum to platinum firing of an Autolite plug. It's part of what makes him a great catch. Autolite, it's time to change your plugs. Dad, how about voting somebody off the driveway?
My technique when I get in the batter's box is to dig in, pull the pant legs up, I try to point the bat to center field, knock the dirt off, and try to look real mean. What do you think of that?
Major League Baseball Charities is a proud partner of Boys and Girls Clubs of America.
Now I want to teach you about pine tar.
Through programs like RBI and Rookie League, they bring baseball and softball to kids around the world.
Don't be afraid of the ball.
Together, they create a positive place for kids.
The biggest stars are on the best damn sports show, period.
Please welcome Samuel Jackson. Arnold
Schwarzenegger. Weeknights on Fox Sports Net.
Don't miss the biggest Fox Sunday ever.
Moises Alou will step in and try to get something going for Chicago. Alou off to a good start. The question always with Moises is, can he stay healthy? But they need him now more than ever without Sammy Sosa in the middle of this lineup and up there hammering at the first pitch, strike one.
Yeah, one of the worst injuries that I've ever seen was that fractured ankle of Moises Alou. He did it right here in St. Louis 10 years ago.
This
1993.
This field was turf. And he had rounded first base. And I will never forget the sight of Moises sitting there holding his leg up with that foot just dangling. And I'm happy to bring that back to your attention, Tim, to give you the shivers on a cold Saturday in St. Louis. Two balls and a strike. After Alou, it'll be Eric Karras and then Corey Patterson. Young player off to a terrific start and really starting to fulfill all the promise that we heard about him years ago. 3-1 on Alou. Moises went through a stretch last week where he hit home runs in four consecutive games. One of them, however, washed out. It was the game Tomko started on Mother's Day at Wrigley. That's out of play, full count.
In that game, it was 11-9 Cardinals after four innings before Bruce Fremming and his umpiring crew called that game. A lot of people question whether that game should have been started, but think about it. I mean, a lot of pressure on the umpires to start the game, to get the gate. Windy City.
Alou flies one into right center field. Drew is back to get it. And the leadoff man is gone for Chicago. All right, here is today's Sprint virtual manager question. Which city is the better baseball town, Chicago or St. Louis? To answer today's question, use your PCS Vision phone from Sprint or log on to foxsports.com. Type in the keyword MLB on Fox. I have my little phone from Sprint. I can take a picture of Christine in the background or Tim.
I finally have a cell phone. You've been on me for years about get a cell phone. That's what Joe's been telling me for years. Well, I finally have one.
And the difference is he doesn't have to pay for it. Good night, everyone. Eric Cara stands in with one out and nobody on. You want to see what you look like there?
Yes.
We've already had to discard three pictures I've taken of you. You're picky. Karras takes a ball down and in. We're also going to have the internet address where you can email us here in the booth. That's coming up in moments. So start your computers, boot them up, get ready to type. Karras is just letting the hair fly these days. Not a care in the world. Has the count 3-0. Long-time Dodger, short-time Cub, and he is merely a backup now to Hesop Choi. 3-0. Not close, and a four-pitch walk with one out here in the second. That'll bring in Corey Patterson. How you feel like you've settled in? You feel good? I know
I do.
Haven't done any games so far this season. You've got a lot of thoughts and stories and things piled up, but you've eased into it today. I'm proud of you.
I'm kind of like Corey Patterson in the booth. Dusty Baker trying to ease him in to a major league lineup, batting him sixth, and a lot of pressure on Dusty to move him up in the lineup, but Dusty said, I'm gonna leave him in a spot in the order to where he is going to feel comfortable. A lot of people, Ron Santo, number one, the great third baseman and now announcer for the Cubs, thinks Corey is a five-tool player. Only 23 years old, 24 years old. He is something.
Well, the Cubs are starting to get paid back for what they thought of Corey Patterson back in 98. In that draft, Pat Burrell was number one. Number one pick overall. Then Mark Mulder went to Oakland. And then Patterson went to Chicago. All 1-1 pitch. Hard hit with foul. And the first base coach, Gene Kline's, almost got a piece of that. So young, so strong. Most career home runs, players under the age of 24. These are active players. This is no historical list. But of those active, you see Pujols, Adam Dunn, and Corey Patterson, who is not yet 24. 2-2 on the center fielder. The reason why there is pressure to move Patterson up is he's one of the few guys in this Cubs lineup that can run. Mm-hmm. They don't have a typical leadoff hitter. Patterson can fly. That gets past his bat, and it's out number two as Tomko picks up his second strikeout.
Good inside fastball from Tomko. And that's good pitch selection from Chris Widger. A lot of times if you miss with that inside slider or fastball, with two strikes on a left-hander, you're reluctant to come back inside on it. Well, Tomko did and had a good result.
And now one of the greatest pinch hitters to come along in a long time. Lenny Harris stands in. Takes a strike from Tomko. You've got Lenny Harris in the lineup today. He's typically a bench player. Send him up at the right spot, get a key hit. But he'll get a long afternoon at Busch today, and he's jammed and pops it up. So Tomko coming inside on the last two hitters, the last two left-handed hitters, and he gets around the one-out walk. We go to the bottom of the second. Pryor back to the hill. No score in St. Louis.
This is the latest.
this isn't. This is the latest. This isn't. And when it comes to athlete's foot, this is the latest. This isn't. Lotrimin Ultra, the latest prescription strength medicine available without a prescription. Lotrimin Ultra, the latest advancement for relief of itching and burning. The latest cure, so ultra powerful, one use a day is all you need. Nothing's proven to be stronger or faster, and nothing's newer. Lotrimin Ultra, the killer cure.
The GMC Yukon XL Denali.
I blow through here, and the music goes down and round.
The tightest turning radius in its class.
And comes on here. Press the first valve down, and the music
professional
goes down
grade engineering.
Round.
It's not more than you need, just more than you're used to.
And comes on here.
Hey, nice car.
Zip Zap's has mutated into the new Mazda RX-8 X-Men car, only at Radio Shack. Cool micro RCs with holofoil trading cards, plus other cool accessories from the movie X2, only in theaters.
You can get your hands on them all.
X2 Zip Zaps and accessories come as shown, each sold separately, batteries not included, some assembly required. From Radio Shack.
After 23 hours, the biggest shock of all still awaits.
You think you'll be safe out there?
You can't do this!
I don't have a choice. None of this was supposed to happen this way!
24, season finale at 9, 8 Central, Fox Tuesday.
MLB on Fox, presented by Budweiser, brought to you by Radio Shack. You've got questions, we've got answers. By GoPhone, only from AT&T Wireless. When you get the best of wireless without a contract, that's M-Life. By new Lotrimin Ultra, the only once-a-day cure for athlete's foot. And by GMC, we are professional grade. Look, kids, the mighty Mississippi. The old man, the old river. Deep river. Cubs have the game's only hit, no score. Bottom of the second, Edmonds first up and a strike on the outside corner. Edmonds, Rowland, and Renteria against Mark Pryor, who struck out Pujols looking on a 3-2 curveball back in the first. Edmonds takes a ball.
Look at Mark Pryor. Well, Mark Twain spent his childhood about 110 miles north of here, Hannibal, Missouri. Old Huck, Tom.
Known as Samuel back then, Mark was.
Sammy.
Edmonds tried to check his swing, could not hold up, and the count 1-2.
Again, gearing for the fastball. And tough to hold up.
This is a mild protest put up by Edmonds, taking his time, speaking under his breath, not digging right back into the batter's box. He didn't think he took a hack at that pitch.
Yeah, and the third base umpire is the guy who called it.
Edmonds pops it up. Left field for Moises Alou. And that's the first out here in the second.
Take a look at the four pitches thrown to Jim Edmonds by Mark Pryor. First pitch, Edmonds taking all the way, fastball on the outside corner. And then Pryor just misses. Here's the key pitch, the changeup. Third base umpire made the call, and the pop-up on the high fastball. Remember in that scouting report, we said that Mark Pryor will throw intentional high fastballs. Not too many young pitchers do that.
Here's Scott Rowland, and there's a high fastball, ball one. Here's my two-bit analysis of Mark Pryor's mechanics. Everything is so tight. It's almost like he's tight in a good sense. He's throwing out of his chest. He really doesn't leave his arm out and exposed. That elbow is in tight next to his body, which I'm sure is one of the reasons why Larry Rothschild, the pitching coach, and Dusty Baker aren't so much worried about the overall pitch count of Pryor. It's really pitches within an inning where maybe his mechanics might break down by getting tired. 2-1 on Rowland.
Mark Pryor really has the compact motion and delivery of a smaller man.
Rowland, left side, base hit. Lenny Harris is not going to cover a lot of ground over at third. One on, one out.
Yeah, Lenny Harris is a hitter that's playing third base today.
And
There it is once again, the motion Joe was talking about. Tight and compact for a big man. You hear that term so often in baseball, a guy who stays within himself. It's a very difficult thing for me to understand. I've never quite understood that term, but if it's true, he does it.
See, the minute you have an out-of-body experience, then you have not stayed within yourself. Mark Pryor does not have any of that when he's on the mound. He stays within himself mentally and physically. One on, one out. Dr. Phil will be back in just a moment. The 0-1 to Renteria. Not close.
Oh, good play by Miller. Damian Miller, a member of the Diamondbacks when they won the World Championship against the Yankees 2 years ago. A fine catcher. Cubs have a couple of good defensive catchers. Paul Bacco, the other, and Dusty Baker saying just to have two catchers of their caliber available during the offseason.
Renteria goes up to get it and flies it into deep left field. We'll hang up for Alou. Two out, rolling back to first. Tito Martinez coming up, and right now here's Jeannie Zalesko with a game break.
Joe, Tim, in the Bronx, the Yankees growing tired this week of the pesky AL West. Lost two or three of the Angels, lost the opener last night to Texas. Today, Carl Everett has the lead with a two-run single. A Robin Ventura two-run home run got the Yankees on the board, but still trailing. And speaking of home runs at Fenway, Monster Seats deserves a monster mash. Nomar Garcia Parr's hitting streak now at 18 Sox lead.
Jeannie, thanks. One on with two out for Tito Martinez. And a ball up and away. Interesting article yesterday in the New York Times about Buck Showalter coming back to Yankee Stadium. Former Yankee manager now in the dugout with the Texas Rangers. The last place Texas Rangers. And ever since he left New York and Joe Torre took over, you know what's happened starting in 96. And Tino Martinez was a big part of it.
Yankees in their first postseason in 95 with Buck Showalter at the helm. First time since 1981.
And in 96, Martinez came over from Seattle, had to take the spot of Don Mattingly. Fan favorite, a baseball favorite. And Tino Martinez really had a good first year after a slow start. Put a lot of that behind him, picked it up. And then had that terrific run anchoring first base for a team that every year seemed to be in the World Series. Not much of a swing there, and it's Gonzalez. That's the end of the inning. We have played two in St. Louis. Pitching has dominated so far. We go to the third, no score. Back after this from your local Fox station.
What begins as an endurance test becomes a question of survival. The Coca-Cola 600 next Sunday on Fox.
You think about what people want in a sports sedan. An available turbocharged engine. A sport-tuned suspension. But you also think about what people need in a sports sedan. Like ABS with electronic brake distribution. You think about that, then you build. The Volvo S60. Performance when you want it. A Volvo when you need it.
We're counting down.
Measuring traffic congestion. Here we go.
Tickets for the Rad Boys, now on sale. Call now. Pick up the phone. Call now.
One concert could generate hundreds of thousands of calls in an instant. At SBC, if we can handle hurricanes, floods, and earthquakes, we can handle the Rad Boys. Ready for anything.
Hello? Any more tickets?
SBC.
My mom loves aromatherapy, so we got her some at KFC.
Now get 10 pieces of your favorite KFC chicken for only $7.99. It's a treat for all of your senses for only $7.99.
Moms really love it.
Ooh, what a lucky man. He wants everything. Turn.
97.1 FM, The Drive.
Thank you.
Introducing the new Nissan Murano. For your adventures in on-roading.
The Final Word with Corey McFerrin and Tom Waddle. Sunday at 10 on Fox Chicago.
8-9-1 for the Cubs. No score. Third inning. And Damian Miller is number 8 in the batting order. Takes a strike. Damian hitting 247. An all-star a year ago with the Diamondbacks. Bob Brenly brought him with him to, where were we? Well, Milwaukee, is that it? Who won that game?
Nobody.
Nobody won that
7-7.
Game. Took me a while to get over that one.
Damian had a good game. 2-for-3 in that game. A couple of doubles.
Two balls and a strike from Tomko.
All-star game being played on the south side of Chicago this year. Comiskey Park. That was the site of the first All-Star game back in 1933.
Three balls and a strike. I don't know if there's time now or with a guy like Pryor pitching with the Cubs in the field to talk about the change in the format as Miller hits a little knuckler out to Edgar Renteria for the first out. Tino Martinez is wearing a microphone for us today. He just made the final out in the bottom of the second, and here's what he had to say to Dave McKay, his first base coach, afterward.
I don't want to swing it.
A sinker?
Yeah, sinker. Three straight ones and a sinker.
What usually happens when a left-handed hitter pulls off a right-hander's sinker? The ball's going away. He's going away. Hit it off the end of the bat.
Here's Pryor with a line drive, base hit into left. Mark Pryor, yesterday during batting practice, hit a BP home run over the stadium club into that Big Mac land area. And even though Mark McGwire has gone into hiding over the past 2 years, they still have Big Mac land up in the upper deck. This guy is a tremendous athlete.
You told me that, Joe. I did not see that yesterday. And when I thought about it, I don't think I have ever seen a pitcher hit a ball in the upper deck in this stadium, batting practice or during a game at any time.
Am I nuts, or a few years ago on an old timers day did I see Bob Gibson swing left-handed and hit a ball into the upper deck into
right? Come on.
Yeah.
Did you really?
I might be nuts. I prefaced it with that, but I seem to remember that.
Really?
Yeah. Well, you know what kind of an athlete he was.
Remarkable. Best athlete I've ever seen.
A strike in at the knees to Gresolonic.
Your father said that Bob Gibson was the best athlete that he'd ever seen, covering all sports.
I don't know if there's a sport that Bob Gibson couldn't have played.
Once played for the Harlem Globetrotters.
There's a hanging breaking ball hit into left field for a base hit. And after the line drive out by Miller, back-to-back line drive hits by Pryor and Gresolonic with Gonzalez coming up.
Last time Mark Pryor pitched was in a game against Milwaukee and up in Miller Park. We talked about it in last year's All-Star game. He had to score from second base. At the time, he didn't have his jacket on. I know that's one of my pet peeves. When a pitcher gets on the base, on the bases, he becomes a base runner, and there's no need for him to wear that jacket. That stuff traditional, and it's stupid. It's not stupid from Mark's standpoint. It's just a stupid tradition, and it should be done away with.
Wow. Boy, you're dangerous with a lot of time on your hands.
Should be outlawed.
Why? Why does that bother you so much?
Well, because it hampers his base running. This guy's a good base runner. You talked about his athleticism. If he's thrown out by a step at home, I mean, that's a run. That's a marker. I know I'm perhaps excessive in my views with that.
With two on, one out. What if he wore a fur out there? Then you could upset Tim McCarver. And people, I guess PETA or whoever doesn't like the whole fur coat thing.
Yeah, perhaps a stole. Maybe.
Yeah, just yes. A stole or a
little jacket.
A pashmina.
Yeah.
How about that? Two balls and a strike on Gonzalez. Just something off the shoulder, something that goes with the uniform. You could go red, white, or blue in this case. Just like a wrap. Enough. Two balls and a strike with two on, one out. 2-2 on Gonzalez. I always love that little dead moment between you and I after one of those
harangues.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's awkward. It's kind of a cleansing feeling, and then yes. We regroup. Chance for the Cubs to take the lead, and it doesn't take much with Pryor on the mound to feel good about the game. Gonzalez chops another one foul. After Gonzalez, it's a left-handed hitting Troy O'Leary, who hit into an inning-ending double play back in the first. Big crowd on hand, but surprisingly, there are empty seats in the upper deck out in right field. I can't remember the last time on a weekend when the Cards and Cubs met, there were empty seats. Two out. What's going on next week? Where will we be? Next week, Fox Saturday Baseball returns with a showdown between old rivals. The Mets look to get back on track as they battle Andrew Jones and the defending NL East champion Braves. The Indians square off against the Red Sox. It all begins next week at 1 Eastern, 12 Central here on Fox. The Mets, who lost Mike Piazza in last night's game against San Francisco, lost the game. Lost Piazza. Right on the disabled list. Before he got back to the dugout with a groin strain, they took x-rays. They were inconclusive, but they don't know how long they'll be without their all-star catcher. On 0-1. One ball, one strike.
See something new in the game every day, or you hear about something new, it seems. Pulling a groin muscle, getting out of the way of a knockdown pitch, or a pitch that was close to Mike. I've heard of perhaps shoulders, things in the ankle, but never a groin getting out of the way of a pitch.
On 1-1, O'Leary with a good swing and a foul straight back. I know, Tim, that you shy away from the whole back when I played stuff, and that's one of the reasons why I love you. But I would say that's probably more a function of the times with guys dug in the way they're dug in.
That's true.
With metal spikes, they have a tougher time moving the feet and getting out of the way of them.
That's true. That's true.
So it wasn't when you played. A little tight. Count 2-2 on O'Leary.
Fastball just missing inside. Tomko and Widger, as we said in the first inning, have used that fastball inside the left-handers to his advantage thus far.
Should end the inning. Vina takes care of O'Leary. Two hits, two left, three on the day for Chicago. Bottom of the third, bottom part of the order coming up. Nut.
Halibut with polenta cake sounds good. Oh, but polenta sometimes makes me break out. I will get, a vegan club sandwich. Vegans are like so in. Is the salmon East Coast or West Coast? That'll just do a number on me.
I can come back later.
Crab cakes. Crab cakes.
Sir?
Porterhouse.
Medium.
Rare.
Slaw.
Cobb.
Ranch.
Blue.
Fries.
Baked.
Toppings.
All of them.
Oh, here's something. Coconut dipped shrimp saute with pilaf. I like pilaf.
Introducing a way to protect your deck gear, the Rubbermaid Corner Deck Box. It fits neatly in the corner. Things fit neatly inside. It's the best thing to hit decks since the barbecue. Get the Corner Deck Box from Rubbermaid. Also for the garage.
Like sourdough bread, burgers just taste better cooked over an open fire. This burger is so juicy. The sourdough bacon cheeseburger is back at Burger King. A quarter pound of beef, Swiss cheese, and four strips of bacon served on buttery toasted sourdough bread. Only back for a limited time.
A breakthrough offer from Midas. Right now, get lifetime brake pads or shoes for just $39.95. And you'll never have to buy brake pads or shoes again for as long as you own your car. Next stop, Midas. Lifetime brake pads or shoes, $39.95. Only at Midas.
The first major advance for the fastest treatment of athlete's foot is Lamisil AT. Lamisil AT is the first non-prescription medicine proven to kill the fungus with just 1 week's use.
Not even a prescription can beat that.
Lotrimin AF and Tenactin still expect you to treat for 4 weeks. Who's going to do that? When your feet itch and burn, using Lamisil AT 1 week keeps you athlete's foot free 3 months. Lamisil AT. There's no better way to cure athlete's foot.
Next week, it's three nights of American Idol. Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, the television event of the season kicks off with your final two contestants. Be there for the season finale that's so big, it takes three nights. American Idol starting Monday at 8, 7 Central on Fox.
The number two overall pick in 2001. Last year, AA, AAA, big leagues. How about the difference this year compared to last from the mouth of Mark Pryor?
Mostly just trying to retain a lot more and use it more on every day than I did, say, last year. Last year, I think everything was such a blur, going from AA to AAA, getting called up, and trying to just be successful. And this year, I think I'm putting things together at times. Other times, I'm still trying to, you know, kind of figure my way around things.
Golden Spikes Award winner, senior season, 7 National Player of the Year awards for Mark Pryor.
If there is anything that is understandable, it's the blur of a first-year major leaguer.
Especially to come in so highly touted, and everybody said, oh, the next Kerry Wood. I think you see some aspects to Pryor's game already that are much different than Kerry Wood's. Tough play. It's a fair ball and the high throw. Widger will hold it first, and we'll see how they call that. They're going to give Harris an error. He did the hard part, picking up the short hop, but then unleashed a wild throw.
You know, we talked about it earlier. He's a hitter playing third base, and it was a fine pickup. Then the long throw is over the head of Eric Karros, and the Cubs are lucky that the ball hit the tarp. That contact right off the end of the bat. And a throwing error on Lenny Harris, and look for Tomko to bunt. And if you're going to bunt, bunt it down third and make Harris feel the ball.
Let's pick on Lenny Harris day.
Well.
In the air, and Karros won't get there.
Really, as a bunter right now, you have either first or third. You can bunt it toward the weakness of Lenny Harris, the third baseman. Eric Karros has to hold the runner on at first base.
Tomko, even with Pryor on the mound, is a guy who likes to swing the bat. Tony La Russa is about as aggressive in this situation as any manager in the National League, letting his pitchers swing. And after those two attempts by Tomko, it might be the better decision. 0-2. Tony La Russa, who will be a part of Dusty Baker's coaching staff in the upcoming All-Star game, the south side of Chicago. Stu got into a war of words during the playoffs last year, the NLCS. Kenny Lofton and Matt Morris kind of started that whole ball rolling. The ball and two strikes.
Remember that high fastball we were talking about? That gives you an idea of how Pryor thinks out there. He throws the intentional high fastball. He noticed that Tomko got under the ball and popped it up. I wouldn't be surprised to see Tomko get another high fastball right here.
Also wouldn't be shocking to see him swing.
No.
Showing it awfully early. Just low. 2-2. An error to start the inning by Lenny Harris. And Tomko, looking at the signs from Oquendo, figure out if he's swinging or bunting. 4 out of 14 swinging it is Tomko this season. What was that?
Slip pitch. Looked like Pryor had the right spike, or a spike on his right foot, hang up on the pitching rubber. And realizing that had he stopped his motion, it would have been a balk, he continues to throw the ball, and Miller makes a nice play. Or was it his left spike on his left foot?
And that guy won the Golden Spikes Award? 3-2 pitch. And the bunt after all that is perfect. Down to second is Widger. Out at first on a sacrifice 1-4 is Tomko.
Realizing now he has to throw a strike, and a good at bat by Tomko after falling behind 0-2. Comes back to bunt, a predictable strike from Pryor.
So now it's Vini and Drew with their attempts to put St. Louis on top. And a smile from Tony La Russa briefly for his pitcher Tomko, who got a bunt down.
We probably heard your remark about the Golden Spikes Award.
Widger at second with one out. Gonzalez to his left. Nothing to it. Over at third is Widger with two out. I have never heard an opposing manager speak as glowingly as Dusty Baker did about J.D. Drew. He is a big fan of J.D. Drew's, and not just because of the 514-foot home run last night. Drew can sometimes frustrate the Cardinals. He's had a difficult time staying healthy. He missed the beginning part of the season recovering from right knee surgery, had tendonitis in the knee. But he's got a boatload of talent. Sometimes will make some mistakes out in the outfield as he did last night. But when he's dialed in, he is a tough out.
Good curveball from Mark Pryor. That's right, J.D. Drew has been an enigma with the Cardinals through his brief career up to now. Sometimes the light goes on a little later. Last night, the light almost went out in right center field. Mercy. Oh.
The very top of the replay board, and it was measured at 514 feet, the fourth longest in Busch Stadium history.
Man.
McGuire has the longest at 545 to dead center field. Runner at third, two out, one ball, one strike on Drew. Too late. 1-2.
Breaking ball strike, then a changeup he missed, and now just blows the fastball right by Drew.
Pryor trying to pitch around an error which started the inning. Can. Breaking ball, Drew is gone. Second strikeout for Pryor, and this game gets to the fourth. Mark Pryor as advertised. Cards and Cubs, no score.
Sosa.
Gates!
Hey, yo! Come on, two out of three.
I don't think so.
Hey, who paid Ruth?
You taking that for heartburn?
Panel of experts recommend it.
More doctors recommend Tums.
Dose for dose, Tums Ultra neutralizes more acid than Pepsi Complete's antacid.
Nothing's faster. Just ask a real panel of experts.
Tums. Now may be the best time ever to buy a Carrier heating and cooling system. Introducing Cool Cash, where you can get a rebate of up to $600 on qualifying new Carrier systems. Call 1-800-CARRIER for a participating dealer.
These people are getting answers to the most important questions they'll ever ask. Questions about their health. They're finding those answers in a single place. WebMD. 16 million people come to WebMD every month. They find vital information that used to be scattered in 100 locations, now all in one place. The place America comes for healthcare answers. A place called WebMD.
From now on, long distance, local, and high-speed internet will be together. Voice and data networks for companies large and small will be together. The innovations of one of the world's largest internet providers and the simplicity of one global network will be together. Together, under one name. MCI.
Drugs, a national epidemic.
The devil invented crack.
Fox Tonight, cops declare war in the most intense undercover operation of the year. A special all-new hour, Cops Drug Wars, at 8, 7 Central tonight on Fox.
No score as we move into the fourth inning. Cubs 3 hits to the Cardinals 1. Mark Pryor good enough to pitch around the error. Committed by Lenny Harris to start last inning, and Moises Alou, the cleanup hitter for the Cubs, leads it off and takes ball one. You can email us here in the booth. You can send us questions, complaints. To his left, Renteria just got a Gold Glove Award before the game and doesn't disappoint, one out. You can be Rudy Martsky for a day. You don't like what you hear? Email it to us. You do like what you hear. Email that to us twice. You have something odd you want to ask. You have something personal you want to ask. Go to foxsports.com. Keyword MLB on Fox. And we'll see what happens. Eric Kara stands in with one out, nobody on. We're up to 268. Go to the tote board. That's how many emails so far. I do Cardinal games, and sometimes we get 2,500 a night. So you national audience people, have a long way to go. Two balls, no strikes on Karros, who walked his first time. After Karros, it will be Corey Patterson. Cubs will head off to Pittsburgh after this. They'll go to Houston. They have a long road trip. It's one of the reasons why Tomko is being careful with Karros. Backhanded pick by Rowland, another Gold Glove Award winner. Two out. Let's go back to May 15, 1960. Don Cardwell just traded from the Phillies to the Cubs in his first start. No hits, the Cardinals.
There's a drive on the line to left field. Come on, Moose.
Great Jack Brickhouse with the call. Cardwell, the first pitcher in history to toss a no-hitter in his first appearance with a new club after being traded. With two out, nobody on, here's Patterson, who struck out his first time, strike one.
Don's no-hitter, certainly noteworthy. Also noteworthy, it was 24 years ago, May 17th, 1979, when the Philadelphia Phillies beat the Chicago Cubs at Wrigley Field 23-22.
Another hit for Patterson, something he's been doing a lot of lately. 23-22, and I guarantee you this, a week ago tomorrow, Mother's Day, it would have been the same type score. It was insane, the conditions that the Cards and Cubs played in, with 40 mile an hour winds blowing out at Wrigley Field on Mother's Day, and they finally pulled the curtain on it after a pitch or two in the top of the fifth inning. And the bad news for everyone involved, unless you were a pitcher, is the stats didn't count offensively, and we may see Patterson run here. But even worse than that, the Cardinals lost Eli Marrero for probably 3 months. And you're talking about a guy who can play anywhere, can catch, can run, hit 18 home runs and under 400 at bats last year. That's a big piece of property that was lost, due in part to the conditions a week ago.
That was a huge loss to the Cardinals. That's why Chris Widger was called up and why he's catching today. And here's a look at what happened last Sunday at Wrigley.
It's not the initial slip, but watch how Marrero right there comes down on his right ankle. His whole body right there, right as we cut away, ended up on the ankle. Widger can't come up with it. Stolen base for Patterson. That's number 8 on the year.
He chose the right pitch on which to run. A changeup in the dirt, and Widger tries to backhand it. Can't find the handle. It's another one of those baseball expressions like staying within yourself. No handle on balls, but a stolen base for Corey Patterson.
So now a hit could give the Cubs the lead. Two ball, one strike count. Now it's 2-2. Brett Tomko, even though his record is 2-2 and his ERA is 4.25, as the second best home ERA in the league at 1.33, his new home. An Ohio native, came up with the Reds in 97, won 13 games in 98 with Cincinnati, and after that was part of the Griffey trade to Seattle, traded to San Diego, traded to St. Louis. And Harris, another foul ball. All the while, I've been trying to type my way in to see what your emails are all about.
Tough to do. There. It's tough to do. Play by play and typing at the same time.
I'm almost there. Go ahead and talk.
Well, the infielder's playing a step deeper with two out and a man on second to knock the ball down if they can't make a play.
Should end the inning into center field. That'll give me more time to type.
All right.
Jim Edmonds, another Gold Glove Award winner. Three of the four Gold Glove Award winners from a year ago helped on outs in this inning.
How about that?
I'll be typing feverishly while we're gone.
Hey, Gina, so where do you suppose he was going?
I think he's sitting at home and he says to himself, today's the day. Today I go for a little ride.
See, this just makes my day.
And that just made my day.
Introducing Picture Mail That Talks from Sprint. And now share all the pictures you want and get a PCS Vision Picture Phone for $99.99 after $100 savings. Share it when it happens.
Senseless garage door destruction. A problem no more thanks to the twice as fast accelerator. Only from Genie.
Hey, nice car.
Zip Zap has mutated into the new Mazda RX-8 X-Men car. Only at Radio Shack. Cool micro RCs with holofoil trading cards. Plus other cool accessories from the movie X2. Only in theaters.
You can get your hands on them all.
X2 Zip Zaps and accessories come as shown. Each sold separately. Batteries not included. Some assembly required. From Radio Shack.
This is the latest. This isn't. This is the latest. This isn't. And when it comes to athlete's foot, this is the latest. This isn't. Lotrimin Ultra, the latest prescription strength medicine available without a prescription. Lotrimin Ultra, the latest advancement for relief of itching and burning. The latest cure, so ultra powerful, one use a day is all you need. Nothing's proven to be stronger or faster, and nothing's newer. Lotrimin Ultra, the killer cure.
What could be bigger than Lois giving birth? The mega-sized Malcolm season finale.
I'm coming, Lois!
A full hour, part of the biggest Fox Sunday ever. Watch the finale, then go to fox.com/Malcolm for the big delivery question from Fox and Mountain Dew Live Wire.
I wonder what he's thinking about. Mike Shannon, the Moon Man, part of this rivalry as a player, grew up a fan of the Cardinals, played for the Cardinals in the 60s, and we'll hear his thoughts on this Cards-Cubs rivalry as we press on through this bottom of the fourth. Albert Pujols first up, no score. Pujols, Edmonds, and Rowland for St. Louis. And strike one. We already have an email from Doug Rogers in Moberly, Missouri. It says, what's it going to take to get the pitch speed displayed properly on your banner at the top of the screen? Divine intervention. Proper word is velocity, just so you know. I was corrected as a young man. Actually, my physics teacher corrected me to correct my father. The 1-1 pitch. 2-1.
Is that true?
That's true.
Is that right?
Yep. Mr. Scott said, I love your dad. Think he's the greatest. But tell him it's velocity, not speed. Two balls and a strike. Pujols smash up the middle for a base hit. Looked like a breaking ball. The replay will either prove that I know what I'm talking about or that I don't.
It was a breaking ball, and Pryor showed the breaking ball. It's a deliberate breaking ball, one that pitchers are trying to throw for a strike as opposed to an 0-2-1-2 curveball.
So now Edmonds, leadoff man, is on for St. Louis for the second time. Widger started last inning, reaching on an error.
Very few times will hitters be honest with people in the media, but in Pujols' heart of hearts, he knows that he saw that curveball coming. A lot of pitchers will wrap the curve. You can see it in the glove. The glove will open up.
Why is it such a slap to a hitter to say that they're a guess hitter?
Well, not a guess hitter, but that he picks up a particular pitch.
But if you say guess hitter, they bat.
I don't understand that. I mean, every hitter either looks for a pitch or a location. Now, I've never really quite understood that. Jim Edwards with the most unusual good swing in the game. That uppercut swing, you hear it from your little league coach. Don't uppercut on ball. A lot of hitters just shake their head in wonderment that he's so successful with it, with that type of swing.
There are times when he just leans back, looks for a pitch up, and has that exaggerated uppercut swing. And when he connects, it's an upper deck shot.
It's amazing. It's almost like he looks like he's swinging uphill.
Tailing pitch for strike two. Good pitch from Pryor.
So far, both strikes, the curveball, the count 1-0, and the fastball on the inside corner 2-1, have Edmonds befuddled.
A leadoff hit by Pujols, a 2-2 pitch to Edmonds. Into left center, that ball's going to drop. Pujols will turn and go to third. Picked up, but that would take two bounces before it got to Patterson, and it's first and third, nobody out.
And a breaking ball. And Edmonds hits this breaking ball like he knew it was coming. It's flat. And that uphill swing again. Good base running by Pujols. And the Cardinals with the biggest threat thus far. Never stopped.
So a shake of the head from Pryor, and now a guy who can rack up strikeouts, part of a staff that racks up strikeouts, needs a couple. Rolling at the plate, first and third, nobody out, and a strike in at the knees. Seeing one of the game's best young pitchers taking on one of the game's best hitting lineups. Breaking ball and Roland laid off. A ball and a strike. Roland singled his first time up. The Cardinals have three hits. They've had a total of four base runners to this point. That's going to get out of play. Strike two. This crowd starts to wake up a little bit after an early Saturday start. 55 pitches. Pryor averages over 100. Dusty Baker under some criticism for Kerry Wood in his 141 pitches last Saturday in a game against the Cardinals. He's sensitive to that criticism. Roland waits for a 1-2.
Another fastball in.
It looked like Roland was waiting for it and still couldn't do much with it. Still 1-2.
I think what Mark Pryor is trying to do right here is to get a strikeout. The Cubs staff leads the majors in strikeouts. And again, that intentional high fastball to Roland. But he's done it twice inside. He'll probably go away here.
That hung up a little bit, backed up even. The count 1-2 still on Roland.
You can see Damian Miller setting up outside now, and the curveball does indeed back up. Those are tough pitches to hit. Pitchers do not throw that pitch by design. They usually grip it too tightly, and it actually backs up on a hitter.
There's a strikeout Pryor wanted, one out. Third strikeout of the day for the right-hander.
Wicked curveball right here, tight with a late break to get rolling.
Thought it was interesting to hear Larry Rothschild say that Pryor actually changed his breaking ball in a start at Colorado because of the altitude. Mm-hmm. You don't get the same type break you would closer to sea level.
He threw more of a slider there and not a curveball. Cardinal fans remember the problems that Daryl Kyle used to have with the curveball in Denver.
Big reason why they ended up with him. First and third, one out. Renteria takes a strike. Good fastball. Well, if the Cardinals have a quote-unquote clutch hitter, he is at the plate. 27-year-old Edgar Renteria. A Game 7 hero in the 97 World Series while playing with Florida. One ball, one strike. I don't know if people around baseball realize the kind of start that Renteria has had to this season. This is throughout the major leagues among shortstops, first in average and RBIs. And that's with guys like A-Rod, Tejada, Garcia Parra, and others.
Dusty Baker thinks Renteria is the smartest player in the National League. High praise.
The 1-1. Two balls and a strike. And Renteria really gets by without a lot of attention. Doesn't talk to the media much, not because he's a bad guy, but he doesn't feel that comfortable with his English, although it's better than he lets on. He kind of gets away with that a little bit. 2-1 pitch, 3-1 with the struggling Tino Martinez on deck. And we'll see how much Pryor wants to mess around with Renteria with a count 3-1.
Another good play by Damian Miller. I think he'll try to throw a strike in situations like this. Renteria loves to go the other way. Got the first baseman holding the runner on and Karras. Redzelanik cheating towards second base for the double play.
3-2.
Tony La Russa thought that ball was high, but umpires are more inclined to give that pitch over the last couple of years.
So instead of a walk, it's now a 3-2 pitch to Renteria. And that's out of play with Edmonds running at first.
When that pitch was on its way, Redzelanik was on the bag and Karras was still on first. The whole right side of the infield just unpeeled for Renteria.
Edmonds was running a moment ago. Moving again, another strikeout, and they have Edmonds hung up. Now Pujols coming to the plate and the inning is over. So a strikeout, then out stealing, and the inning comes to a close. And now Pujols is jarring with a home plate umpire, Mark Hollowell, because of that 3-1 strike call to Renteria. So a big chance for the Cardinals, and the big young pitcher, Mark Pryor, gets out of it. No score after four.
What a good feeling, a great sensation. Combination. Sock it to me.
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 Ooh, baby, I started.
Yes, I did.
But I can't stop it.
Hey, Tom, I told this guy you make a great sandwich. Tell him.
Well, I start with a rich blend of savory Monterey and cheddar cheeses. Then add flavorful herbs like garlic, dash oregano, a pinch of rosemary.
Sounds like a great sandwich.
Sandwich? That was just the bread.
Great bread makes a delicious sandwich. That's why Subway has a line of gourmet breads like the tasty new Italian urban cheese. Fresh baked with garlic, oregano, rosemary, topped with Monterey Jack and cheddar cheeses.
Ready to hear more?
I think I'm ready to eat.
Subway!
Welcome back to the Haviland 500. And checking the Haviland running order, the Haviland 42 car is moving up.
Yeah, boy, take a look at that Haviland Speedo and Haviland Tack on McMurray's ride.
Let's time this lap with a Haviland stopwatch.
That Haviland temperature gauge says this engine's running good.
It's time to pay some bills. Folks, this race is brought to you by,
Haviland Motor Oil.
Yep, now back to racing.
I tell you what, it's easy to see why Jamie's doing so well.
And thanks for these beautiful overhead shots from the Haviland Blimps.
The best things in life are pure. Aquafina, purity guaranteed.
Amazing stories of the will to survive. She was stabbed 23 times but never gave up.
I wasn't going to lay there and die.
And this woman was led to safety by a dog. Bring their attackers to...
First pitch of ball to Damian Miller, the number 8 hitter, with Pryor on deck, and then back to Gresolonic. No score, fifth inning. Cubs have out hit the Cardinals 4-3. And that's off to the right. Martinez won't get there, and it's out of play. Strike one. Get an email from a viewer in Chicago. Says, hey, Joe and Tim, my comment is Dusty Baker is, in my opinion, the big factor for the Cubs to win the division and go on from there. What are your thoughts? And then he threatens us by saying, remember, Ron and Pat on WGN are just a button away. So knock yourself out. That's into left field off the end of the bat, and Albert Pujols will go to it. One up. We're going to look at the end of the bottom of the fourth inning on what ends up being Pujols caught stealing 2-4-2.
Yeah, Pujols is committed to run right here, but once he sees Edmund stop in time, in other words, in time to get back to first base, all bets are off. So Albert could see that Edmonds had stopped soon enough to get back to first base, which he did. And then Pujols broke anyway. Watch Edmonds in the top of your screen stop. Now that's in time. But once Gresolonic sees Pujols take off for home, he threw, and Pujols was an easy out at home plate.
Pryor standing at home plate now. A home run this season, a 292 average, including his base hit back in the third. 2-1.
I couldn't agree with that emailer anymore about Dusty Baker. He's brought such a positive influence to the Chicago Cubs. I mean, here's a team that has not won a World Series in 95 years.
Into left field, that ball's going to get down for another Pryor hit. And these aren't cheap hits. He's hit two rockets out to left.
You can see Tomko shaking his head. It looked like a slider. You can see Widger sitting outside. That slider backed up, and Pryor 2-for-2 today. So another knock from Mark Pryor.
So Pryor is on with one out. Tomko, a shake of the head, and here's Gresolonic. Part of what was supposed to be a revamped bench for Dusty Baker. And Gresolonic was supposed to back up at second base. It was really one way that the Cubs were able to get rid of Todd Hundley and ship him to the Dodgers. But Gresolonic was supposed to back up Bobby Hill, who again could not make the cut in spring training. So Gresolonic is starting. Karros is starting today. Harris is starting today, as is O'Leary. All guys that at the beginning of the season were supposed to be there to support off the bench.
We talked about Renteria and his penchant to go the other way with a runner on at first base. Gresolonic similar in that regard.
Two balls and a strike. Gonzalez on deck. So two hits for Gresolonic today, a 308 average. Can handle himself at second base. It's been a nice addition to this Cubs team. Breaking ball for a strike, and it's 2-2.
slider a bit too high out of the strike zone. That high hanger that goes so far is right around the belt. Anything above that, it's actually too high.
Off the hands, another hit, third of the day for Grzelanik, and it's two on with one out.
The Cubs have six hits on the afternoon, three by Grzelanik, two by Mark Pryor, the pitcher. The other hit, a single by Corey Patterson. There has not been an extra base hit in this ballgame thus far.
Cubs have hit into one double play today. Gonzalez trying to put Chicago out in front. I'm not saying that Mark Pryor listens to the broadcast, but I'm pretty sure that he's wearing a different jacket out at second base.
It's one that's not buttoned up.
This is a little more forgiving. It's not as bulky.
It's not a boa either.
Here's an 0-1. One ball, one strike.
Boa, good crossword puzzle word, by the way. B-O-A.
There's a guy who spends a lot of time on airplanes. This is a little more streamlined. And available yours for your purchase at the Cubs gift shop in Wrigleyville. Stop by today. 1-1 pitch. Off the end of the bat, easy for Edmonds. And this inning will belong to Troy O'Leary, who will bat with two on, two out. O'Leary so far 0 for 2 in hitting .218, hit the ball hard his last time up. Tomko wants a new baseball. Come on, emailers. I'm looking at the same group of emails. FoxSports.com and type in the keyword MLB on Fox. O'Leary has 11 RBIs. Tomko again trying to get out of trouble, and O'Leary is out in front of that pitch.
Breaking ball too far out in front. That's a fastball swing and a slider.
One and one. Julio Munoz in Chicago wants to know if this is the biggest rivalry in baseball. You could get an argument out of those who follow the Yankees and Red Sox, the Dodgers and Giants. That's low, 2-1. We'll hear an interesting soundbite from Mike Shannon, which we set up but never heard. And I think he put it best that there's really no animosity. It's a good-natured rivalry between the fans of each of these two teams. That's a little inside. The count 3-1, and the Cubs in a good spot now where O'Leary should get a pitch to hit. And Moises Alou waits on deck.
Compared to the Yankee, and there Tony La Russa wanting that high strike because of that 3-1 pitch that was called on Renteria. But a little more bitter rivalry, Yankees-Red Sox.
Now the bases are loaded for Alou. Two hits, a walk in the inning, and the Cubs' best run producer, Moises Alou, at least their cleanup hitter with competition for that title from Corey Patterson, will bat with a sacks jammed and two out.
Boy, Tony La Russa very hot in the Cardinals dugout, wanting that pitch right there. That was a two ball, one strike pitch. Remember, a manager cannot go out of the dugout, leave the dugout to argue about a ball or a strike. He's safe there if his language is so.
Good chance for the Cubs, albeit with two out. And it looked like Tomko tried to guide that breaking ball in, and he missed with ball one. Pryor with a hit to get this started. He's at third. Grzelanik, his third hit of the day, and a walk to O'Leary. A 1-0 pitch to Alou. On the 1-1. The numbers for Moises in his long career, 2 grand slams. A 286 start for Moises Alou. 24 RBIs, bases loaded, 2 out. 2 balls and a strike.
When you think about it, 2 out grand slams are tougher than none or 1 out grand slams. The reason is you're a little more relaxed with less than 2 outs, realizing a fly ball will score the runner from third. But a 2-out grand slam, very, very difficult.
Here's a 2-1 pitch from Tomko. 3 balls and a strike. Well, if it's difficult with 2 out, it's made a bit easier with a count 3-1.
That's right. Now he has to throw a strike. Alou will look middle in. Try to jerk one.
Down the middle, full count.
You can see Alou kicking himself, not offering. Of course, it was outside part of the plate, probably looking middle in and taking anything else.
Runners will go. 3-2 pitch. Out of play, and we'll have to do it again.
I'm a little surprised with O'Leary with fair speed on at first base that Tomko is not stretching. By winding up, you get that runner at first, that little extra jump where he could score on a long single, short double.
Alou trying to put Chicago out in front. The first place Chicago Cubs. Won't take advantage. Out is Vigna, in is Edmonds, and Vigna takes it away from the center fielder. The inning is over. Alou flies out, shallow center, and this game remains scoreless halfway through it.
Well, I had a really nice time tonight.
Me too.
Well, I guess it's getting late.
Yeah, it's getting late. Yeah, it's getting so dark.
See ya.
Call me.
Hey, Mom. The rat, he looked at me. And then he started to sleep. And then the rat, he looked at me again.
I can't believe I'm getting this emotional over a rat.
Somehow I doubt it's the rat.
Introducing Pixar Mail that talks from Sprint. Share it when it happens.
Recently, all the winners of the Car and Driver Best Pickup Award got together for a little reunion. It's good to see everyone again. Silverado, the 3-time winner, the only winner of Car and Driver's Best Pickup Award. Silverado, a truck from Chevy. The most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
It's the biggest Fox Sunday ever, featuring the Simpsons season finale with 2 all-new episodes.
Woo-hoo!
When Mo becomes the kid's babysitter, what could go wrong?
Looks like Maggie spit up over here and crashed her tricycle into the wall.
And no, that was me.
The Simpsons 1-hour season finale at 8, followed by the 1-hour Malcolm season finale, Fox Sunday.
MLB on Fox, presented by Budweiser, brought to you by Chevy Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road, by Sprint, introducing PCS Vision, clearly a whole new way to look at wireless, by Pepsi Cola, experience the joy of Pepsi, and by the Sourdough Bacon Cheeseburger. The Sourdough Bacon Cheeseburger is back for a limited time at Burger King. Cook in over an open flame. Good game. No score, bottom of the fifth, Martinez, Widger, and Tomko. Bottom 3 in the order as Pryor got out of a first and third nobody out jam last inning, and Tomko just got out of 2-on-1 out, then bases loaded, 2-out situation in the top of this fifth. Martinez hits a rocket to right, right at O'Leary. Some of the best contact against Pryor today for the Cardinals. Our Pepsi fan. Here's Widger, who takes a strike over the outside corner.
It would have been very easy to write that song 3-2 the count, as opposed to 2-3 the count. That song popular in my high school days. Chuck Berry, one of my favorite.
Did that catch your attention?
It did.
You said 2-3
the
count.
It did. Never caught my attention before this morning.
One ball, one strike, one out, nobody on. Widger hits a foul. Strike two.
We would do, I know this is going to sound so square and corny, but we would do the bop to that song.
Really?
B-O-P. Not hip-hop, bop.
That was down in Memphis.
Down in Memphis, yes.
Yes. If you were a Chuck Berry fan, where was Elvis on your radar?
Oh, man. I was a fan of Chuck. Elvis.
You lived for him.
He was an icon.
Five strikeouts for Pryor. Two out, nobody on, and Tomko will walk to the plate. Do you agree with the assessment that this rivalry between the Cards and Cubs has more of a good-natured feel between the two fan bases?
Yeah, I think so. We touched on it briefly last half inning. New York and Boston, that bitterness over the years is, I think, the futility of the Red Sox winning since 1918. That has gone hand in hand with that bitterness, and the Yankees so successful.
We'll hear from Mike Shannon when we come back about the rivalry. Then a rebuttal from Ron Santo of the Cubs. All that coming up.
When you can get the best of wireless without a contract, that's M-Life. Go phone. Only from AT&T Wireless.
Now may be the best time ever to buy a Carrier heating and cooling system. Introducing Cool Cash, where you can get a rebate of up to $600 on qualifying new Carrier systems. Call 1-800-CARRIER for a participating dealer.
Like sourdough bread, burgers just taste better cooked over an open fire. This burger is so juicy.
The sourdough bacon cheeseburger is back at Burger King. A quarter pound of beef, Swiss cheese, and four strips of bacon served on buttery toasted sourdough bread. Only back for a limited time.
I've made a lot of news on the baseball diamond, but if you want to find out about this diamond, you got to go talk to your doctor.
Ready to try Viagra for the first time? See your doctor and find out if a free sample's right for you.
My doctor says it's right for me. That's why I stay with it. For more information, go to Viagra.com.
Viagra congratulates Rafael Palmeiro on his 500th home run.
Piazza and the Mets battle Chipper and the Braves. Fox Saturday Baseball next week.
Don't miss the biggest Fox Sunday ever.
He played for the Cardinals. He's been broadcasting for the Cardinals for over 20 years. Mike Shannon and his thoughts on this Cards-Cubs rivalry.
I think it's the best because it's not like the Yankees in Boston where it's kind of bitter. This is really not between the players. I mean, it's forced on the players because of the fans. This is between the fans. The rivalry's been there a long, long time, and there's a number of reasons that have fueled it over the years. But basically, it's been handed down from one generation to the next generation, and it's the fans that make it the best. And there's nothing nasty about it. There's nothing vulgar about it. It's very wholesome. It's Midwestern.
Well said. Mike's thoughts. We'll hear from Ron Santo in just a moment. As you look at the number of times these two sides have met, the Cubs lead the all-time series. However, Lately, it hasn't been too good for the Cubs here in St. Louis. As Tino Martinez takes care of that, we'll give you those numbers after we hear from Ron Santo and his thoughts on this rivalry.
I don't feel, and that's just my opinion, that it's as great as when we played the Cardinals, because there was just something special, and there was, it was very intense. There was always a fight somewhere, and Mike Shannon was always in the middle of it.
Mike Shannon was always in the middle of it. That's what Mike's always told me, so at least that's verification. As Corey Patterson takes a ball up and away, Corey with a line drive hit to center his last time up.
Of course, seven of those years that Ron played, Leo DeRocher was the manager of the Cubs, and if there wasn't a fight, Leo made sure that there was a fight on teams that he managed.
But a lot of those rivalries have been watered down because of free agency, because players move around. You don't grow up in an organization hearing about how you're supposed to not like the Cubs or how you're supposed to play the Cardinals differently than other teams.
That's an interesting point. You think of those Cub teams of that era.
Two out.
Think of Billy Williams, Ernie Banks, Randy Hundley, Glenn Beckert, Donnie Kessinger, Lou Brock in the early 60s, and then he came to the Cardinals on June 15th, 1964, the thing that arguably won the Cardinals three pennants and two world championships in 5 years. The Cardinals were the same way. For the most part, a set lineup. There was a change of guard in the middle 60s. Roger Maris obtained.
Base hit for Lenny Harris on with two out. But you talk about that Brock trade, Tim, and that's really become the infamous trade, the Lou Brock-Ernie Broglio trade.
Yeah.
Not only broke the stolen base record August 13th, 1979, after getting knocked down, I remember as a kid being here at this game, knocked down by a pitch from Dennis Lamp right before that, Lou Brock got his 3,000th hit, hitting one off Dennis Lamp for a base hit.
Oh, is that right, a hit, Dennis Lamp?
Right after getting knocked down.
What a way to go. Wonderful.
Stan Musial got his 3,000th hit against the Cubs at Wrigley.
At Wrigley, right.
As a pinch hitter late in the game.
Mm-hmm.
Came in as a pinch hitter because they didn't want to start him and have him get 3,000 on the road, but they needed to win a ball game.
Who was the announcer for the Cardinals then? Jack Buck and you know who?
Harry.
Musial. He used to love to say Musial. It was always Musial.
There's the trade. All the specifics, but all that people talk about is Brock for Broglio. One on, two out, two balls, no strikes. The great Bing Devine putting that trade together.
Right.
They could swing by Miller on a 2-0 pitch. It's 2-1.
It's like the right shoulder of Chris Widger. A lot of times managers will note that and run on the next pitch. There's something to that too. Not necessarily the shoulder, but if a catcher gets one off the hands, regardless of the speed of the runner at first, sending. Good time for Harris to be running.
Damian Miller on 2-1, 2-2. Miller has four home runs, his average 242. Get an email from Chad Barker of Decatur, Indiana, who asks, how do announcers keep from cheering on their favorite team? My answer to that is you take care of your own business.
Yeah, that's easy, really.
People don't believe that, but it is easy.
It is.
One on, two out, two balls, two strikes, and the inning comes to a close. Oh my gosh, the inning came to a close. Tomko got out of it.
Woohoo!
See, I could keep from doing it. No score.
Our customers expect a website that delivers instant results, like Progressive.com. Buy car insurance instantly from the site rated number one 7 times in a row. Visit Progressive.com.
senseless garage door destruction. A problem no more thanks to the twice as fast accelerator. Only from Genie.
A breakthrough offer from Midas. Right now, get lifetime brake pads or shoes for just $39.95. And you'll never have to buy brake pads or shoes again for as long as you own your car. Next stop, Midas. Lifetime brake pads or shoes, $39.95. Only at Midas.
Hey, nice car.
Zip Zaps have mutated into the new Mazda RX-8 X-Men car. Only at Radio Shack. Cool micro RCs with holofoil trading cards, plus other cool accessories from the movie X2, only in theaters.
You can get your hands on them all.
X2 Zip Zaps and accessories come as shown, each sold separately. Batteries not included, some assembly required. From Radio Shack.
We're really close.
And we need to talk constantly,
even when we're not together. So
we need a calling plan that lets us talk as much as we want,
whenever we want, at no extra charge.
With Singular's Family Talk Plan, call each other for free with unlimited mobile-to-mobile calling. Get 5,000 night and weekend minutes to share, up to 3 additional lines, and up to 4 free phones.
We call it the Jordy
and Julie
sister-to-sister plan.
Come into Singular now to find the plan that fits you best.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the Commissioner of Baseball and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form, and the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without express written consent.
Dusty Baker, Tony La Russa getting together. Dusty excited about getting a chance to taste this rivalry in person. Today's Sprint Virtual Manager question, which city is the better baseball town, Chicago or St. Louis? You have answered using your PCS Vision phone from Sprint or logging on to foxsports.com and typing in the keyword MLB on Fox. Just about split. And a ball misses the outside corner. Pretty good pitch from Pryor. Doesn't get the call. Vigna, Drew, and Pujols for St. Louis in the bottom of the sixth inning. Hard hit, base hit. Vigna's been getting hotter as the season has worn on. Had 3 hits erased in that washout on Sunday. Adds to his .241 average here to start the sixth.
High fastball from Pryor, the fourth Cardinal hit, all singles. I wonder how many teams, Joe, would even be considered good baseball towns if they had two teams that were at times as feudal as the White Sox and the Cubs. I mean, the Cubs haven't won in 95 years. Last time the White Sox won a World Series, 1959.
The bunt is a fair ball. Harris fires. Good play by Lenny Harris. First had to decide whether he'd let it roll or pick it up and try and get the out. He picked it up and made a strong throw for the first out of the inning.
I'll tell you, good play also. Vigna, good base runner. Alex Gonzalez thinking ahead. This is a catcher's responsibility. A catcher should come down the line. Damian Miller didn't do that, but look at Gonzalez in the foreground going to third base to prevent Vigna. This is a sacrifice by J.D. Drew, but big thing is a ball down the third baseline that's bunted. The catcher continues down the line to guard third base.
Pop up right side, playable for Karras. Good pitch in on the hands of Pujols. 2 out. We will give you our Subway in-game box score. And it looks like this for the Cardinals. Vigna on with his first hit to start this inning. The sacrifice by Drew, who was looking at the ground ball instead of keeping his head forward and running hard to first base. Pujols has a hit. Edmonds does. Roland had the first Cardinal hit of the day. The best scoring chance of the day belonged to St. Louis in the fourth. First and third, nobody out, and Pryor got out of it.
Joe, you made a comment earlier that the only guy perhaps who could get in on Albert Pujols was a guy like Pryor, and he just got in on him for a key out. That fastball, even though Miller wanted it outside, that pitch was inside, and it ties up Albert Pujols for a big out for Mark Pryor.
Runner at second, 2 out, 1 ball, no strikes. Edmonds leans back from ball 2. .315 average for Edmonds, who started this month hitting .402.
I would be surprised if this is a fastball.
Rolling on deck. It was not. The count's 2-1.
Sometimes you get an idea about what a pitcher wants to do. A breaking ball. It's just difficult with the count 2-0 to look dead breaking ball. You almost know he's not going to throw a fastball. That was a good curveball from Pryor.
3-1. No runs on the board. 11 hits total, and the Cubs have 7 of them. In fact, the Cubs have left 8. Cardinals only 3. Each side has turned to double play. How much does Pryor want to challenge Edmonds with a count 3-1? Two on with two out. First walk of the day by Mark Pryor. Walks are a rarity. That's another aspect of how good Mark Pryor is. A lot of strikeouts. They're not strikeouts. The balls are being put in play, and there are very few free passes.
And there's no way to prove this because you've got a runner on at second base in a tie game in the sixth inning. But I don't think Mark Pryor walks Edmonds if there's one out or if he's leading off an inning, something like that. That was one of those unintentional intentionals.
So now it's up to Roland for St. Louis. Now we're getting into good emails. See if we have a chance to get it in. If we don't, we'll do it next inning. Two on with two out. No score. Sixth inning. Roland hitting .290. All one. Cubs in their half of the seventh will have Pryor to start it. He's already 2-for-2. Then Grisolanic and Gonzalez.
Pretty easy to look at outfield alignment, and right now the Cub outfielders are giving Roland, they're playing the lines too much. In this ballpark, you have to cut down what is hit through the gaps. In my view, O'Leary should be 5 feet to his right and Alou 5 feet to his left. Right center, left center are wide open.
3-0. Renteria next. So the first walk of the day for Pryor to Edmonds, and now it's 3-0 on Roland.
See how much room is from left to center field and then from center field to right. Here we go. Too much in the gap.
A four pitch walk to Roland to load him up for Renteria. And Rothschild's going to come out and talk. So here's the email from Matt in St. Charles, Illinois. He says the only way to tell if you're in Chicago or St. Louis is to look at the arch or to look at Wrigley Field, because the crowd is so split between Cardinals and Cubs fans. That's why it's the best rivalry. But then he throws this bar. Next poll question. Which happens first? Cubs win it all, or Pryor gets his 300th win for the Braves? You going to take that, Chicago? Huh? That came from just across the river, and you can log on by using foxsports.com and use the keyword MLB on Fox.
That reference, obviously, to Greg Maddux and pitching for the Atlanta Braves right now, when allowed to be let go from the Cubs.
After a Cy Young season.
Yeah, it seems like eons ago.
So now it's Renteria against Mark Pryor. Strike one.
Fastball inside. And Pryor ahead in the count.
Miller through the signs. Renteria waits with the bases loaded. Like he's trying to go to right. The count's 0-2.
That's why you pitch hitters inside. If they're trying to go the other way, the pitch inside is tougher to hit the other way than the pitch away. I think Damian Miller's using the second sign behind the plate. So that's a breaking ball, if he is.
Footer for ball one.
Catchers, of course, will use different signs with runners on at second base. And it was a breaking ball played nicely by Damian Miller.
A look from the eyes of Mark Pryor. Bases loaded, two out, no score, sixth inning. Renteria off the end of the bat. Broke his bat and the inning is over. Each side now has left the bases loaded in an inning today. And there is no score as we go to the seventh. In St. Louis, back after this from your local Fox station.
What begins as an endurance test becomes a question of survival. The Coca-Cola 600 next Sunday on Fox.
Some people may not be comfortable talking about hydroform steel frames, but they'll be comfortable riding on one. The 2003 GMC Envoy is the only SUV in its class with a full-length hydroform steel frame for a smooth, comfortable ride, which makes our competition very uncomfortable. Get 0% APR for 60 months for qualified buyers on a 2003 GMC Envoy, or get $3,000 cash back. See your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana GMC dealers.
My daughter was born at 8:33 a.m. At 8:34 a.m., my mom's on the phone in tears asking when she could see her granddaughter. A minute after that, she does.
Introducing the cool new camera phone from Singular. Just shoot and email instantly to your friends and family. It's simple. Plus, sign up for select calling plans now and you'll get this sleek Sony Ericsson camera phone free.
I call it the Tim Simcoe Smile for the Phone plan.
Come in today and see how Singular fits you best.
Swing into spring savings on PlayStar Play Centers at Menards. The Champion features swings, rings, climbing rocks, and a curved slide. Your kids will have hours of fun. On sale, $499. Accent summer nights with solar-powered landscape lights by Brinkman. They're simple to install because there's no wiring needed. A two-pack of kettle lantern or window pane lights are just $29.99. For great lights, head to Menards.
Save big money at Menards.
Change the way you move through the world. The V6 Nissan Altima.
The Final Word with Corey McFerrin and Tom Waddle, Sunday at 10 on Fox Chicago.
Mark Pryor leads it off, seventh inning, and he hits one into deep right center field. Well hit. Back at the track at the wall. It's off the wall for a double for Mark Pryor. He is doing everything he can today. During the last at-bat, Tino Martinez was talking it over at first base about the hitting ability of Mark Pryor.
Yeah, he's got good balance and mechanics at the plate, you know? He ain't just hacking. He's up there with his trying to get a good pitch, yeah.
He just got a good pitch, and this is what he did with it. He got the base hit there. He had a single earlier, and now he doubles into right center field off the wall. That's a long poke.
Well, you were talking about Pryor hitting last night, hitting one in the upper deck. He just wants the lower deck with this one to right field, about 5 feet from a home run. His third hit of the day.
Rez Salonik trying to advance him. Drew came in, goes back, and Pryor with good base running, tags and advances, one out. And a good productive out by Grisolano.
I'll tell you, earlier in the game, we were talking about Dusty Baker and Edgar Renteria, how he's one of the smartest players of the game. Watch how he tries to get in between Mark Pryor and the outfielder J.D. Drew in fielding the ball. That way, you mess up the timing of the base runner. Inexperienced base runner. You could see Renteria getting in between Mark Pryor and J.D. Drew in right field. Often, you will see a third baseman try to do that with a guy tagging up at third with less than two outs. Not knowing when he catches the ball. You don't know when to leave the bag. But that's an example of Renteria and how smart he is.
Our GMC game summary. GMC, we are professional grade. We're in the top of the seventh inning. No score, but a great chance here for Chicago. Pryor's doing it on the mound and at the plate. Tomko, strong start for the Cardinals. Grzelanik has three hits. A combined 0 for 12 with runners in scoring position today. Alex Gonzalez, king of the walk-off home run, is up here in the top of the seventh inning trying to produce a run. Pryor at third, one out. Caught. Bad break for Chicago. Good break, St. Louis. Two out.
The harder you work, the luckier you get. A rope to Roland. That's a ball, if Roland's back in his normal position, is a tough ball to field. Not only a line drive right at him, but because the Cardinal infield was in a line drive that he could handle.
So now it's Troy O'Leary, and the Cubs ask O'Leary for a two-out hit. Troy is 0 for 2. He's bounced into a double play, grounded out, and walked. He walked immediately before Alou popped up with the bases loaded back in the fifth. We're in the seventh, no score. Runner at third, two out. And ball one.
What a great game. Think about this. How many times have you seen the top of the seventh inning where a starting pitcher is 3 for 3 and it's a nothing-nothing game?
I don't think I ever have. As O'Leary takes ball two, 2-0, with Alou hoping to get another chance on deck. O'Leary playing in place of the injured Sammy Sosa. Can he come through with two outs for the Cubs? 3-0. On the outside corner, 3-1. Leadoff double by Pryor. Solanic fly to right to advance the runner. Gonzalez lined out. That's low. It's ball four, and it's first and third, two out. Three walks today for Tomko to go with his four strikeouts and eight hits allowed. And another chance for Alou. Moyes is number two on the Cubs club with his 24 RBIs. Low again, it's 1-0. Oh. 108 for Tomko, who has a complete game this season. Dusty Baker and Tony La Russa this season have let their starting pitchers get deep into games and get the pitch counts up over 100. 1-0 pitch. 2-0 with Karros next.
The Cubs rank number one in pitches thrown by their starters. The Cardinals rank number three in pitches thrown by their starters. Stronger bullpen for the Chicago Cubs.
Tony La Russa almost has to do it out of necessity.
Yeah, right.
Because of his bullpen.
Mm-hmm.
Here's a 2-0 pitch to Alou. Into right field. J.D. Drew on the run. Long run. He can't get there. It's a fair ball. One run scores. Here comes O'Leary, and now they've called it a ground rule double. So O'Leary will go back to third, but the Cubs have taken A 1-0 lead. So Pryor, who started the inning with a double, finally crosses home plate with the first run of the day as a result of this.
The Cardinals got a break on the line drive by Gonzalez for the second out in the inning. They get a break here because the ball bounces high enough to be out of the ballpark above the yellow line. Clearly. And that holds O'Leary to third base. Otherwise, he scores easily.
So now it's second and third for Eric Karras. As Moises Alou finds a safe spot in the outfield for that ground rule double. Karras 0 for 2. Takes a ball. St. Louis in the bottom of the seventh inning will have Martinez, Widger, and then the pitcher spot. To the shortstop, Renteria. Karras not running well, doesn't run, and the inning is over. Moises Alou hitting cleanup, puts Chicago on top. It's time to stretch in St. Louis, 1-0.
Hey, Tom, I told this guy you make a great sandwich. Tell him.
Well, I start with a rich blend of savory Monterey and cheddar cheeses, then add flavorful herbs like garlic, dash oregano, a pinch of rosemary.
Sounds like a great sandwich.
Sandwich? That was just the bread.
Great bread makes a delicious sandwich. That's why Subway has a line of gourmet breads like the tasty new Italian urban cheese. Fresh baked with garlic, oregano, rosemary, topped with Monterey Jack and cheddar cheeses.
Ready to hear more?
I think I'm ready to eat.
Subway!
Senseless garage door destruction. A problem no more thanks to the twice as fast accelerator. Only from Genie.
A breakthrough offer from Midas. Right now, get lifetime brake pads or shoes for just $39.95. And you'll never have to buy brake pads or shoes again for as long as you own your car. Next stop, Midas. Lifetime brake pads or shoes, $39.95. Only at Midas.
When you can get the best of wireless without a contract, that's M-Life. Go phone. Only from AT&T Wireless.
Ooh, you're a naughty little boy, aren't you? Keep it up, and I'm gonna give you a spanking. I'll teach you the meaning of respect. You're not getting any of my butt legs. Do you hear me? No kisses for you. Not till you learn to obey me. Now, get down on all fours.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
MLB on Fox, presented by Budweiser, brought to you by Bud Light. For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light. We welcome you back to St. Louis. Joe Buck and Tim McCarver with you. I'd like to have you towering over me like that. I knew we were coming on camera, but I just wanted to pop up and show the world that I'm actually 2 inches taller than you.
How about the day that Mark Pryor is having, though? He scored the only run of the ball game. He has almost as many hits as the team against whom he's pitching, the Cardinals. He has three. The Cardinals have four. What a performance out of the big, strong right-hander from San Diego. Man.
Tino Martinez is first up, the number seven hitter, Widger, and then the pitcher spot. And a ball misses outside to Pryor. So a 1-0 Chicago lead and a two-out ground rule double hit by Moises Alou in the top of this inning. That caught the corner. It's 1-1. Steve Kline getting loose, so in the right situation, the Cardinals will pinch hit. They may do it anyway with Tomko's pitch count. Martinez out in front of that pitch, hooks it, foul. Strike two. They announce a crowd of 45,000 plus here in St. Louis. They had about 2,000 tickets and seats returned before last night's game for today. And there are some empty seats, but not many. A 1-2 pitch to Martinez. Good pitch inside corner, one out. Nasty breaking ball for the out. Next week, NASCAR returns to Fox with exciting NASCAR Winston Cup racing. Live from Charlotte, the world's best drivers compete in the Coca-Cola 600 as Mark Martin tries to defend his title in the longest race on the Winston Cup circuit. NASCAR returns Sunday, May 25th at 5 o'clock Eastern, 2 p.m. Pacific on Fox. Last week in the Busch race across the river, St. Louis native Kenny Wallace running in the Monte Carlo. The Cardinals paint job all over it, finished 10th.
Did an article about Kenny the other day. St. Louis Cardinals on the side of the car.
And it looked like this as Widger takes strike one. One ball, one strike. Big Cardinal fan, and we see him here at Busch Stadium from time to time during the season. 1-1 pitch. Widger takes a fastball, just poured in for strike two. This is the Mark Pryor show. Whew. To this point. Orlando Palmeiro on deck to pinch hit. And now Tony La Russa and the home plate umpire Mark Hollowell are back into it. And La Russa has been kicked out. And so now he'll get his money's worth.
Third questionable pitch called by Hollowell as far as Tony La Russa is concerned. The high fastball to Renteria. That is the key pitch in this game.
You can just see him right there say it. If you can read lips at all, you can see him talk about Renteria.
Mm-hmm.
So he's still hot about that pitch. The pitch to Widger doesn't really matter.
Yeah, at the time, there were runners on at first and third and one out with Renteria the batter. And it was a 3-1 pitch. So had the pitch not been a strike, obviously the Cardinals had the bases loaded and one out. As it stood, Renteria struck out. Pujols was tagged out on the attempted double steal. And that's why La Russa is in on this argument. He's already been run. It's always been my theory that most players or managers are run on day games after night games because you don't get a lot of rest and tempers are apt to flare. Tony La Russa has spent the last two innings flaring that temper and he has run from the game.
He got bounced at Wrigley last week. He's ejected for the third time this season and Hollowell wouldn't dare call a strike on a borderline pitch after that. It's 2-2. One out, bases empty. That argument really was about the pitch to Renteria, as Tim mentioned, and Widger almost comes out of his shoes on that pitch. Cubs have 9 hits to the Cardinals 4. A dominating effort from Mark Pryor. 2-2 pitch. That's down the left field line. It is foul. Go back to that pitch to Renteria. This would have loaded the bases for Tino Martinez, a 3-1 delivery that was called strike two instead of ball four.
Key pitch in this ball game.
Instead of bases loaded, one out for Martinez. Renteria stayed at the plate. Widger's had two good swings and Alou is back to take care of it. Two out. Orlando Palmeiro's appearance here will signal the end of the day for Brett Tomko, who went 7 today, allowing 1 run on 9 hits. The run was earned, 4 strikeouts and 3 walks. Klein will be next out of the bullpen for the Cardinals. Palmeiro hits one off the glove of Pryor. To Gonzalez, base hit.
What a rope. Whew. Getting the thing marked prior, superhuman. Watch this. Off the thumb of the glove. And Gonzalez almost turns it into an out. But Palmeiro beat it and helped first base umpire Mark Wegner with the call. Wow.
So now it's Vina, who's 1-for-3 today with Palmeiro at first. Palmeiro just got his World Series ring from the Anaheim Angels. Part of their bench for Mike Socia last year as Vina takes a strike. Only Palmeiro and Alex Ochoa, the two members that were part of that World Series championship roster that didn't return this season. Both actually signed with the Cardinals. Ochoa ended up in Japan. As Vina grounds to Karros. That's easy, and that's the end of the seventh. So Tomko is finished. Klein will take over, and Fryer keeps on rolling. Eighth inning in St. Louis. 1-0 Chicago.
$16 million people will come to WebMD this month. Some will learn about a condition or a diagnosis. Others will chat with experts. Many will simply decide when to visit a doctor. We'll help them all to navigate WebMD's wealth of medically reviewed information to find exactly what they need. Americans may have thousands of different questions about their health, but now they have a single place to find the answers.
The fire temperature is the secret to great-tasting sourdough bread. Like sourdough bread, burgers just taste better cooked over an open fire. This burger is so juicy. The sourdough bacon cheeseburger is back at Burger King and better than ever. A quarter pound of beef cooked over an open fire. Two slices of Swiss cheese, four strips of bacon, lettuce, and tomatoes all served on buttery toasted sourdough bread. Only back for a limited time, so you gotta get in now.
It's the biggest Fox Sunday ever.
I tell you what.
First on the one-hour king-sized King of the Hill season finale, Hank uncovers a coven of witches.
Hey, Dad, meet the guys.
Bah!
Then the Simpsons season finale is double stuffed with two all-new episodes.
Woo-hoo!
And Mo becomes the kid's babysitter. What could go wrong?
Maggie's gone!
Looks like Maggie crawled through these bushes, spit up over here, and crashed her tricycle into the wall.
No, that was me.
And what's bigger than the one-hour mega-sized Malcolm season finale? Lois giving birth. But will Hal get there in time?
I'm coming, Lois! I'm coming!
The biggest Fox Sunday ever starts at 7, 6 Central.
1-0 Chicago as we go to the eighth inning. Steve Klein, first out of either bullpen today. The numbers for Klein are not good. This has been a frustrating start to the season for the left-hander, who has always been one of the most dependable as far as a guy who will answer the bell day after day after day. For a while was used as the Cardinal closer. Was ineffective and then basically had a meltdown after a game talking to the media where he thought he was finished, or at least said so. Mike Crudale is getting loose as Klein will work to Corey Patterson to start this eighth inning. Bottom part of the order, Patterson, Harris, and Miller. If anybody gets on prior, with the Cubs up 1-0. Strike one on a pitch down and in. Hard hit. J.D. Drew. A leap and a catch. One out.
Watch how J.D. Drew drops down at the last minute and then goes up to make the catch. You often hear that the toughest ball hit to a center fielder is the ball right at him. Right fielders too. That ball was scorched.
So now we will have Ramon Martinez come off the bench and bat for Lenny Harris. So they're going to add to their defense here. and replace the left-handed hitting Harris with the right-handed hitting Martinez, a former Giant, came over with Dusty Baker. But in the late innings in a one-run game, Dusty Baker is going to get the glove of Lenny Harris out of the lineup. After strike one, it's ball one. In the bottom of the eighth, St. Louis will have Drew, Pujols, and Edmonds. Strike two on Martinez.
Like a slider that disappeared on Ramon.
268 average, a home run, 10 RBIs. Should be the second out. Tim McCarver earlier talked about trying to change the mindset of the Chicago team, something that Dusty Baker wanted to do right at the beginning. Here are his thoughts on doing just that.
The power of belief, composite thinking, and also, the fact that, we're not losers, and we don't have to be losers, and change the attitude and the mindset, hopefully the town, and the press, and the players, and the whole organization, the mindset of the whole organization that, hey, man, we got to figure out a way.
Said before the game, he has not been reminded of history so much since ninth grade. That every time we do something, fans in Chicago know so much about the history of the franchise and say, oh, that's the second time that's happened since 1932. That's the first time since 1958 that's happened. And if you want some Cubs history, it's been 14 years since a division title, 1989. Last time they had back-to-back winning seasons, 71 and 72, to go back 31 years for that. Last World Series appearance, 1945, and 95 years since their last World Championship. Yet Wrigley Field is still one of the most special places in the United States. And just a jewel sitting on the north side of Chicago.
How many franchises get a manager who was in the World Series the prior year? You have to wonder if the Giants win the World Series, would Dusty Baker still be in Chicago this year? I think he would be.
You still think he was gone?
I think he was gone. I think he wanted to leave. I think Dusty thought 10 years is enough. Time to move on.
The division and the rift between Dusty Baker and Peter McGowan, mm-hmm. who owns that Giants franchise, was so deep. There wasn't much to be done. Martinez will take care of Damian Miller, and that'll send this game quickly into the bottom of the eighth. Mark Pryor, Brett Tomko, and Steve Klein doing their best today. Try to help time of game. 1-0 Cubs.
Sosa.
Jace.
Hey, yo. Come on. 2 out of 3.
I don't think so.
Hey. Who paid, Bruce?
Hey, Gina. So where do you suppose he was going?
I think he's sitting at home and he says to himself, today's the day. Today I go for a little ride.
See? This just makes my day.
And that just made my day.
Introducing Picture Mail That Talks from Sprint. And now share all the pictures you want and get a PCS Vision Picture Phone for $99.99 after $100 savings. Share it when it happens.
These people are getting answers to the most important questions they'll ever ask. Questions about their health. They're finding those answers in a single place. WebMD. 16 million people come to WebMD every month. They find vital information that used to be scattered in 100 locations, now all in one place. The place America comes for healthcare answers. A place called WebMD.
After 23 hours, the biggest shock of all still awaits.
think you'll be safe out there.
You can't do this!
I don't have a choice. None of this was supposed to happen this way!
24, season finale at 9, 8 Central, Fox Tuesday.
MLB on Fox, presented by Budweiser, brought to you by Pepsi Cola. Experience the joy of Pepsi. By WebMD, the place America comes for healthcare answers. By Midas Auto Service Experts. Midas, we do that. And by Sprint, introducing PCS Vision, clearly a whole new way to look at wireless. Big inning here, obviously, for the Cubs, up by only a run. The 2-3 and 4 hitters for St. Louis, Drew Pujols and Edmonds against Mark Pryor. We get an email from Chris Greek in Spangdahlem Air Base, Germany.
Wow.
Who asks, if you were Dusty Baker, wouldn't you think about moving Pryor up in the batting order when he pitches? He's due to lead off in the ninth inning if he makes it that long. Remlinger and Alfonseca getting loose, and Drew taking ball one. So this will probably be it for Pryor. And the Cubs trying to guide him through this eighth. 2-3 and four hitters, 1-0 Chicago. Into left center field, well hit. Patterson on the run. Diving catch by Patterson for the first out of the inning. What a play by Corey Patterson.
Remarkable play when you consider that the ball is going away from Patterson when he stretches out as far as he can. He lay there after the catch, and rushing over was Moises Alou, thinking he was hurt, but he's fine. A lot of times you dive like that and an outfielder will curl that glove up and cause very serious injury. It almost happened to Corey Patterson, but just a brilliant play.
Pujols hammering at the first pitch, pops it foul and out of play. You have to wonder if, with the way Patterson's swinging the bat, the way he can run, the way he's moving around in center, if we're looking at a future star here in the National League.
I think so.
What a big play at the right time for Chicago, leading off the eighth inning, especially with Pujols and Edmonds coming up. It's been a fun game here today in St. Louis. And a good way to start the Fox Saturday baseball game of the week. A 1-1 to Pujols, who's hit 9 home runs. That's down the left field line. This ball is gone. 10 home runs in a 1-1 game. The 107th pitch of the day from Mark Pryor is going to be his last, and it's hit out down the line for the 10th home run of the season for Pujols.
You can get that inside fastball by him once, but not twice.
You talk about quick bats. Bonds, Sheffield, Soriano. Talk about Pujols. Pryor knows it now. We're tied at one.
Breakthrough offer from Midas, America's trusted leader in brakes. Right now, get lifetime VSD brake pads or shoes for just $39.95 at Midas, and you'll never have to buy brake pads or shoes again for as long as you own your car. So how do you find the time to repair your brakes without stopping your life? The answer is Midas, for fast, reliable brake service. Hurry into Midas today for lifetime VSD brake pads or shoes. Next stop, Midas. Lifetime brake pads or shoes, $39.95, installation extra at Midas.
Hey, Tom, I told this guy you make a great sandwich. Tell him.
Well, I start with a rich blend of savory Monterey and cheddar cheeses. Then add flavorful herbs like garlic, a dash of oregano, a pinch of rosemary.
Sounds like a great sandwich.
Sandwich? That was just the bread.
Great bread makes a delicious sandwich. That's why Subway has a line of gourmet breads like the tasty new Italian urban cheese. Fresh baked with garlic, oregano, rosemary, topped with Monterey Jack and cheddar cheeses.
Ready to hear more?
I think I'm ready to eat.
Subway!
Now may be the best time ever to buy a Carrier heating and cooling system. Introducing Cool Cash,
where you can get a rebate of up to $600 on qualifying new Carrier systems. Call 1-800-CARRIER for a participating dealer.
This is the latest. This isn't. This is the latest. This isn't. And when it comes to athlete's foot, this is the latest. This isn't. Lotrimin Ultra, the latest prescription strength medicine available without a prescription. Lotrimin Ultra, the latest advancement for relief of itching and burning. The latest cure, so ultra powerful, one use a day is all you need. Nothing's proven to be stronger or faster, and nothing's newer. Lotrimin Ultra, the killer cure.
The biggest Fox Sunday ever has the biggest shock of the season.
Maggie's gone!
It looks like Maggie properly pushed it spit up over here and crashed her tricycle.
No, that was me.
The Simpsons season finale with two all-new episodes at 8 Fox Sunday.
Mark Pryor will not get his sixth win of the season. He came in leading the National League in victories and ERA because of this from Albert Pujols.
Yeah, I think there are reasons, not just a reason, why Dusty Baker removed Mark Pryor. Not because of the home run necessarily, but because of the ball that was played by Corey Patterson so beautifully in center field. And then the home run. So two balls hit that hard, and Dusty said, well, he's gone long enough.
Jim Henry is the general manager of the Cubs, and what a terrific job he did in bolstering this bullpen. It is definitely a strength for Dusty Baker, and it will be a battle of the bullpens the rest of the day. And Mike Remlinger, who was so good for Atlanta his first year with the Cubs, his numbers as he deals with Jim Edmonds. 1-1 in the bottom of the eighth. Ball one. Edmonds now with Roland on deck. 2-0. Alfonseca still getting loose for the Cubs out in their bullpen. Edmonds has hit 8 home runs. 3-0. Tony La Russa has been ejected from this game, so he is either right up the tunnel or at the top of it watching this game on TV, still with his hands on the controls of what happens the rest of the way. 3-0 pitch. A high strike. It's 3-1.
All fastballs from Remlinger have been high. Jim Edmonds, a high fastball hitter. Another fastball.
Full count. In one-run games, the Cardinals are 2-10. The worst record in one-run games in the major leagues. It's a 1-1 game right now in the eighth, and Edmonds stays at the plate with a full count. They're 4-5 in two-run games. And many of the critics of this Cardinal team around St. Louis have pointed the easy way, which is right to the bullpen and to the bullpen alone, but this offense has gone into spells where it hasn't produced many runs.
It has definitely sputtered at times, and Walt Jocketty, the general manager, will tell you the same thing. One thing Remlinger will have to guard against is that high fastball away. Edmonds with good power the other way.
A 3-2 pitch. Two out. And Edmonds really struggling at the plate. The bases are empty, and Scott Rowland is coming to the plate. Now, the Cubs started the day with two veteran left-handers in their bullpen. They started the game with only one. Just prior to the game, they put Mark Guthrie, the left-hander, on the disabled list with left elbow tendonitis, and they've called up Phil Norton, the left-hander. Who was pitching out of the bullpen at Iowa. With two out, here's Roland. Going for the pump. Strike one. The Cubs in their half of the ninth will have the pitcher spot. Grisolanic and Gonzalez. Brown has 8 home runs as he looks at ball one high. That's next week. Mets, Braves, Indians, Red Sox. Rolling today is walked, singled, struck out. That was against Pryor. Strike two. From the left-hander Remlinger. A spectacular play by Patterson started the inning, taking an extra base hit away from Drew, and that was followed by a Pujols home run to tie it. Good numbers in this matchup for Roland, but set up at a ball and two strikes. One and two. Roland strikes out, and Remlinger does his job, comes in, strikes out Edmonds and Roland, and that sends this fun Saturday game between the Cards and Cubs tied going to the ninth. It's 1-1, thanks to that from Pujols.
In 1935, Foxwood Farm started with one horse and a truck. The horse was a thoroughbred, the truck a Chevy Suburban. Today, they have a few more horses, but there's still only one truck. Chevy Suburban. With an available 8.1-liter Vortec engine, it's capable of towing up to 6 tons, making it the best Suburban yet. Chevy Suburban, like a rock.
When you can get the best of wireless without a contract, that's M-Life. Go phone. Only from AT&T Wireless.
Introducing a way to protect your deck gear. The Rubbermaid Corner Deck Box. It fits neatly in the corner. Things fit neatly inside. It's the best thing to hit decks since the barbecue. Get the Corner Deck Box from Rubbermaid. Also for the garage.
You know I like you. And I like you a lot. I like Janice a lot, too. And I know she's your roommate.
Janice?
I'm not sure how to say this to you. You know that I like you a lot, right?
Yeah.
It's just that I like Janice a lot, too, and I know she's your roommate, and I would...
So date both of us.
What? What did you say?
Drugs, a national epidemic.
The devil invented crack.
Fox tonight, cops declare war in the most intense undercover operation of the year. A special all-new hour, Cops Drug Wars, at 8, 7 Central tonight on Fox.
Steve Kline pitched a 1-2-3 eighth inning. He'll work to Bellhorn, leading off as a pinch hitter, batting for Remlinger, who went two-thirds of an inning with two strikeouts. And he takes a ball. Bellhorn has been used in the leadoff spot. He's really hit just about everywhere in this lineup. Joe Borowski, who's been the closer for the Cubs, gets loose. 2-0 from Kline. Kline, whose motor runs at about 110 at all times, brings home a 2-0 pitch. 3-0.
Sometimes that can be a deterrent to a pitcher, but not to Steve.
Oh. 3-1.
Is that last year's hat, by the way?
I think he's worked that one over in the short time that the 2003 season has been underway. Full count. Dusty Baker has Really been frustrated with the hitting approach of Bellhorn, taking a lot of fastballs and swinging at breaking balls, wondering what he's looking for and why he's not taking hacks because of the kind of talent he has. That's off the plate. Bellhorn is a guy who last year hit 27 home runs but drove in only 56.
A lot of times taking in the wrong situations when you have men on base, that's when a selective hitter becomes a first ball hitter.
That's right at home plate.
And sometimes it's not your talent, it's your approach. It's your approach to the game, it's your approach to defense, offense, forgetting your offense when you're playing defense, controlling things. It's a hard game to play, but it should not be a hard game to think.
On 3-2, another foul tap. Bellhorn, this is really the spot with this Cubs team. The people believe that if the Cubs stay in contention and you approach the trading deadline, which I fully believe they will with this kind of rotation and the kind of talent they have pitching, that the third base spot will be the spot they go after to try to improve. Bellhorn is typically the starting third baseman. Lenny Harris got the start today, and Bellhorn hits it to deep left. It's 2-1 Chicago on a home run by the pinch hitter Bellhorn. While names like Hillenbrand and Lowell and others are bandied about as possible trade baits, so to speak, for the Cubs, here's Bellhorn pinch hitting and hitting a home run to put the Cubs back out in front.
Dusty Baker is saying to himself, that's what I'm talking about. That ball was rocketed out of here.
And only his second home run of the season. Now Grzelcyk, as Klein stays in the game, takes a ball.
Looking fastball, and he got it. Man, that got out of here in a hurry.
Pretty good rip by Grzelcyk. It's 1-1. One ball, one strike. Nobody on or out. The Cubs have regained the lead, and Grzelcyk pops it up into right center. Drew puts it away, one down. The Cardinals in the bottom of the ninth will have Renteria, Tino Martinez, and then Chris Widger, the scheduled hitter. Here's Gonzalez. So a rare smile from Bellhorn, who's been frustrated this season. Dusty Baker pulled the right string, sent Bellhorn to the plate. He rewarded him with a home run. Now Gonzalez takes a ball. Alex, who has 5 walk-off home runs since joining the Cubs last year. More than anybody in baseball over that span. Get a lot of emails, whether it's locally or I saw a few today. What is a walk-off home run? A walk-off home run is to take the swing, the ball leaves the park, and everybody walks off the field because the game's over.
As opposed to a ninth inning, put your team ahead home run, where you still have to go back on the field. Think about that at bat by Bellhorn. That was not a good at bat. It ended well. He swings through a 3-1 pitch, and then he fouls off 2 balls futilely. Looked like he was topping everything, and then boom. Just gives you an idea about the talent that he has. If he can corral that talent, Cubs could have a third baseman for a while.
On 2-1, Gonzalez takes ball 3.
Swings through 3-1, 2 foul balls, then this. He crushed it.
3 balls and a strike, and Gonzalez. And a walk with 1 out. So the Cardinals going down the line with Steve Kline. He had a 1-2-3 eighth. He's allowed a homer and a walk here in the ninth. And as they meet on the mound, we'll tell you the producer of today's game is Jeff Gowan, the director Bill Webb, the associate director Jason Wormser, Steve Horn assisting us in the booth, the broadcast associate Eric Billigmeier, our technical producers Matt Benedict, studio show produced by Gary Lang, directed by Bob Levy, and the associate director is Jennifer Love. Senior producer of the studio show, Scott Ackerson. Jack Simmons, the supervisor, as O'Leary stands in with one on, one out. And a close play at first, but Gonzalez able to get back. The senior producers, Fox Sports' Bill Brown, the executive producer, David Hill, and Angora. That in no way means that any of us believe this game is over, but in case time gets away from us in the end, you to know who's behind the scenes of our debut of Fox Saturday Baseball. We've had a good game here today. 2-1 Cubs in the ninth as O'Leary waits. His feet moving all over in the batter's box as that pitch was delivered. Strike one. He wasn't ready for that pitch at all.
It's a Fred Astaire stance.
Like my golf swing. Cha-cha-cha.
That low strike given to Steve Kline.
So the count 0-1. On deck is Alou, who has an RBI double. That misses, a ball and a strike. Again, bottom half of the order coming up for the Cardinals in the bottom of this ninth inning, and they will be taking on Joe Borowski, who was very close to giving up baseball altogether. He's made a comeback, and all of a sudden, he's the anchor in the Cubs' bullpen, a first-place team. There's a strike, and it's 1-2 on O'Leary.
Joe Borowski had two major league saves before this season. Two.
It bounced around, pitched in Mexico. Thought about giving up the game entirely, becoming a firefighter like his father. It's very close, and here he is with the Cubs. O'Leary's feet moving all over the place, and a check swing he couldn't hold up, struck him out, two out. Unless I have not been paying attention prior to now, I haven't seen his feet do that in any other at bat today as he faced a left-hander for the first time.
That's a Hal Morris approach to hitting. Hal, the former first baseman for the Cincinnati Reds, used to have mobile feet like that.
Only problem is that's not Hal Morris.
No, that's true.
That's Troy O'Leary.
It's not Fred Astaire either.
No. Steve Kline is finished. Mike Crudeil coming in with Alou coming up. 2-1 Cubs.
What are you doing stinking up my stuff?
These things are magic, Mikey.
Anybody can hit in these. Anybody, huh?
The new MLB Authentic Collection Performance Batting Practice jerseys and caps are here. Now anyone can get them.
Fox Tonight. Drugs, a national epidemic.
The devil invented crack.
Now cops declare war in the most intense undercover operation of the year. A special all-new hour. Cops, drug wars. Then amazing stories of the will to survive. Stabbed 23 times, she never gave up.
I wasn't going to lay there and die.
And this woman was led to safety by a dog. Bring their attackers to justice. America's Most Wanted. It all starts at 8, 7 Central tonight on Fox.
Buckle up.
My baby!
Your baby!
For the biggest Fox Sunday ever.
Wow!
It's an all-new night featuring three hour-long season finales.
I tell you what.
First, it's the king-sized King of the Hill, where Bobby joins a coven of witches.
I know a girl repellent when I see it. I want grandchildren. Will you fix this?
Then, the Simpsons season finale is double-stuffed with two all-new episodes.
Woo!
When Moe becomes the kid's babysitter, what could possibly go wrong?
Maggie's gone!
Looks
like Maggie crawled through these bushes, spit up over here, and crashed her tricycle into the wall.
No, that was me.
And on the mega-sized Malcolm season finale...
I'm having the baby here!
It's the miracle they've been waiting for!
No!
But will Hal make it home in time?
I have to get home to her! I'm coming, Lois! I'm coming!
3-hour-long season finales, one huge night. The biggest Fox Sunday ever starts at 7, 6 Central.
Mike Crudale is into the action as he deals high and tight to Moises Alou. Crudale trying to finish off the top of the night. The Cubs have regained their one-run lead. Look for more, and here are the numbers for Crudale.
Only his fifth appearance. He started the season with Memphis, the AAA affiliate of the Cardinals. Recalled on May 2nd.
That's a strike. It's 1-1. He, being Crudale, the big part of the bullpen mix last year as a rookie, 3-0 in 49 games with a 1.88 ERA, but was so ineffective in spring training, they sent him out. We're really disappointed with the way he came back. And he broke his foot early in his season at Memphis as he drives Alou off the plate, 2-1. But it was the presence of Crudale that allowed this Cardinal team to let Rick White walk away, Dave Veers walk away. He's with the Cubs on the disabled list. Thinking that Crudale would set up Isringhausen, and neither one of the two were ready to go at the start of the season. A big reason why the Cards have that poor record in one-run games. Breaking ball is hit to left. That ball stayed up, and it's two on with two out.
That looked like a splitter. The thing about throwing a splitter is you have to stay on top of it. Otherwise, it stays up in the strike zone. If you think about it, you just drop your hand to the right, and you almost push the ball. And that's what Crudale appeared to do against Moises Alou. Easy pitch to handle then.
Now Karras is off to a good Cubs start, 21 out of 63. A 333 average, batting with two on, two out. Popped up behind the plate, and that'll get back and out of play.
Joe, when you think about the Cardinals' loss of Jason Isringhausen, you'd be hard-pressed to look at any major league team and think about any other team losing as much as the Cardinals have lost in Isringhausen. Now, you might think of Mariano Rivera with the Yankees, but think of all the backup the Yankees have for a guy like Rivera. The Cardinals don't have any. And that's what makes Walt Jocketty's job a lot tougher.
And lately, it's been Cal Eldred.
Yeah.
Who's been the closer. Saves the last two games. That's the third. Tough play. Rowland with a backhanded short hop pickup. And the inning is over. That sets up the bottom of the ninth. Joe Borowski coming in to try and close it. Home run, Bellhorn, 2-1, Chicago.
What begins as an endurance test becomes a question of survival. Next Saturday, the Busch Series on FX. Next Sunday, Winston Cup Racing on Fox.
It's one of baseball's fiercest rivalries. Piazza looks to power the Mets back into the NL East hunt as they battle Chipper and the red-hot Braves. Saturday baseball next week. Check local listings.
On the biggest Fox Sunday ever.
I'm having the baby here.
The miracle they've been waiting for is here.
No!
But will Hal make it in time?
I have to get home to her. I'm coming, Lois. I'm coming, Lois.
The one-hour mega-sized Malcolm season finale after The Simpsons Fox Sunday.
Next week, the countdown to the American Idol finale begins with three nights of music and excitement. Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, the television event of the season kicks off with your final two contestants. Be there Monday for a finale so big, it takes three nights. American Idol, starting Monday at 8, 7 Central on Fox.
Hello.
Jack.
than Amy. Now.
The past 23 hours have been filled with surprising twists.
Three countries colluded to explode a nuclear bomb on our soil, and we have proof.
But the biggest shock of them all still awaits.
You think you'll be safe out there?
Now, the series that rewrote the rules of television suspense.
You can't do this!
We'll break them again.
I don't have a choice. None of this was supposed to happen this way.
Whatever you do, don't miss the powerful season finale. 24 at 9, 8 Central, Fox Tuesday.
He's pitched in Monterrey, Mexico. He's pitched in the Independent League with the Newark Bears. Double switch as Hee-Sop Choi comes in to play first base. He bats ninth. Ramon Martinez has been in the game at third base, and on the mound is Joe Borowski, who is six for his first six in save chances. Now 0 for his last two. One of those blown saves against the Cardinals. And he will deal with Renteria, Tino Martinez, and at least Chris Widger's number eight spot in the order with the Cubs up 2-1. Good rip by Renteria, strike one. Borowski's been at it professionally since 1990. Came to the Cubs in 2001. Got into only one game after working at Iowa. Good year at Iowa. And then last year, in 73 games, had a 2.73 ERA. Now he's the closer. On 0-1. Renteria pops it up. Foul. It's back and out of play. Alfonseca, the closer for the Cubs, started the season on the disabled list with a calf strain, hamstring strain, and Borowski filled in as the closer. They did so well. Now Alfonseca's back, healthy, but wearing a jacket and smiling in the bullpen while the Cubs try and win a 2-1 game in St. Louis.
Yeah, we mentioned Borowski with only two career saves prior to this year, and now he's tripled that number. We did the game when he broke into the major leagues back in 1996 with Atlanta, and we noted then that he had been working on a split finger fastball in the minor leagues, and the first one he threw was at the big league level.
Here's a 1-2 pitch into center field, might fall, will fall, and the leadoff man is on for the Cardinals. It's the league's leading hitter, Edgar Renteria.
Off the end of the bat, good piece of hitting with two strikes by Renteria. Under any other circumstances, with another hitter up there, you'd ask him to bunt. But Tino Martinez, there's the contact right off the end of the bat. Tino Martinez will not be bunting in this situation.
Tino Martinez has not had many of those glory moments in a Cardinal uniform. Cards, Cubs, 2-1 Chicago. Bottom of the ninth inning, Renteria's running. A late swing, Renteria's safe. And the tying run in scoring position.
What a jump by Renteria. What a play by Damian Miller. A late swing by Martinez. The hit and run was on here. Watch this quick release by Miller to make it at least close. Renteria had a walking lead at first base. And steals his fourth base in five tries on the year.
Now Martinez with an 0-1 count. Isn't this exactly what Dusty Baker talked about before the game about Renteria? Quick strikes. He takes a nasty pitch down and away, flips it into right for a hit, and then steals a base. And he's in scoring position with nobody out in the ninth.
Most guys would be very tentative on a hit and run play and make sure the hitter put the bat on the ball. Not Renteria. He had a good jump and steals second rather handily.
One ball, one strike on Martinez. The Cardinal fans come alive. That advances the runner. Gonzalez gets the out at first, but Martinez does his job. And now a former Cub, Miguel Cairo, will come up with his chance to tie it. Cairo will bat for the catcher, Chris Widger.
Joe, I remember a conversation between you and me about 3 years ago as Larry Rothschild, the pitching coach, comes out to talk to Borowski. And you were telling me Tony La Russa's philosophy about squeezing anytime, any place, with anybody. And if that is true, and it certainly is, then now's a pretty good time for it with Cairo the batter. And I'm sure Rothschild is talking to his infield and Borowski about that very thing right now, or at least mentioning.
While they talk on the mound and the home plate umpire, Hollowell goes out to break it up. Here is, to this point, today's great feat of the game presented by Loterman. A pinch hit, go-ahead home run off Klein by Bellhorn to make it 2-1.
Nobody warming up in the bullpen. That trip to the mound was about strategy. What to do with Cairo.
Borowski's trying to save it for Remlinger. Borowski, 25 strikeouts and 20 innings pitched coming in. The infield is in for the play at the plate. Tying run at third, one out, ninth inning. That'll get out of play for strike one. Renteria bluffed to go off third with that pitch as Eduardo Perez is, I guess, near the on-deck circle. Can't say in the on-deck circle because he's halfway to home plate already. A little mid-May drama in St. Louis between the Cards and Cubs.
Great game.
One of the best pinch hitters in the league last year, Cairo, so far this season 0 for 11.
That's the best way to thwart a squeeze, is to get ahead of the hitter.
Last year, Cairo hit 322 off the bench. Cardinals picked him up from the Cubs. Borowski needs a strikeout. And he gets a pop-up. That'll do just fine for the Cubs. Two out. It takes a hit. Big pitch by Borowski running in on the hands of Cairo.
In on the hands and neck high. You can see Miller with the high target. He either wanted the strikeout or the pop-up. He gets the latter. That's what Cairo needed to hit that pitch. A ladder.
Martinez pulled it in, and now with two out, it's Eduardo Perez. Perez batting for Crudale. Three home runs, seven RBIs. As a pinch hitter, three out of nine this season. Strike one. The inning started with a hit by Renteria into right center. Stole second on the first pitch to Martinez, who didn't get the hit but advanced Renteria to third. The pinch hitter Cairo popped up. And now it's up to a battle between Borowski and Eduardo Perez.
Renteria is trying to get Borowski to balk. He took a fake break off of third.
Time called before the pitch. We'd like to welcome those of you watching the Red Sox and the Angels. We've had a good game in St. Louis. 2-1, the Cubs lead. We're in the bottom of the ninth. Renteria is at third with two out. He was there moments ago with one out, but Cairo popped up, and Borowski's trying to save it for the Cubs. Eduardo Perez pinch hitting at the plate. One ball, one strike. Borowski taking his time between pitches. Matheny with his catching gear on, hoping to get a chance to use it today. A 1-1 pitch. Just so you know, after Perez, Fernando Vina would be the hitter. Borowski into quick trouble in this ninth inning, trying to get out of it. Into right field. There is O'Leary on the move, and the game is over. Cubs win in a final of 2-1. Pitching dominated today, and it's the Chicago Cubs bullpen that beats the Cardinal bullpen. And these two teams have split the first two games of a four-game set.
Things were laid out pretty well for the Cardinals, with Renteria opening the ninth with a base hit, stealing second base. But after Tino Martinez got him to third, the Cardinals could not play to run it.
Four Cardinals received their Rawlings Gold Glove Awards before today's game. It was the guys on the mound that were the most impressive. Mark Pryor, Brett Tomko. In the end, it was Borowski getting the save for Chicago. A fun start to Fox Saturday Baseball. Coming up, Jeannie Zelasco and Kevin Kennedy in the Fox Television Center. From all of us, so long.
Gentlemen, thank you. Tonight, NASCAR Winston Cup Racing live from Charlotte returns to FX with the Winston. The best drivers in the world go racing under the lights in NASCAR's all-star event. Coverage begins tonight, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, only on FX. Hi, everyone. Welcome inside the Fox Network Center. Jeannie Zelasco, along with Kevin Kennedy. Seen some good ball games today for our opening day, yes?
Saw some good ball, great ball games. You know, the thing in right field with Trot Nixon, and we saw that with Larry Walker a couple of years ago. Sometimes guys have mental lapses out there.
Yeah.
And I think it probably happened with Trot because the foul ball that was not made, the play was not made. He maybe thought, well, maybe there's a second out, and that was a third out. So
never underestimate how difficult it is to count from one to two.
Yeah, and you can't have those in a pennant race when you're playing the Yankees and you're battling your one game out and you get a chance to tie today.
Well, they're in the same boat with the Yankees this week, who've been dealing with the pesky AL West. Let's take you to Fenway. Let's see what went on, shall we?
Well, this is what went on. Troy Gloss right there, a two-run home run. That made it 3-2. Angels a comeback again for Anaheim. They came back four down yesterday, Jeannie, and they went on to win this thing 6-2. And Jared Washburn, the key, pitched very, very well today. Kept everybody in check.
And so 2 of 3 from the Yankees, and ready to do the same with
They've won 8 out of their last 11. Now, we know the Angels played better against the Yankees the last 4 years than anybody in baseball, but Fenway Park, they don't always have a lot of success. Even Percival, as was mentioned on the game by Jerry Remy and Josh Lewin, he struggles sometimes in Fenway Park. But today he got it done, and last night he got it done. And the offense, it's key, because the Angels, if you remember a year ago, the Angels came back many, many times, especially the second half of the year. We saw it all during the postseason. They're starting to catch fire. They've won 8 out of 11.
Well, I guess also key, and Mike Socha's been saying this all season, we're really not going to get on a roll till we can get our starters really to get past 5 1/3 and 5 2/3. And Jared Washburn with his first complete game ever of his career, but about a week and a half ago,
yeah,
and pitching well again today.
Well, he was hurt in spring training, got off to a slow start, but he's pitching better lately. The earned run average is in the high threes now. And here's the key for Jared Washburn. Men on base right here. Manny Ramirez right here. The jam shot, infield in. That's one of the best RBI producers in the game. Manny Ramirez averaging 133 RBIs a year for the last several years. And then Shea Hillenbrand got plus 30 RBIs this year. Another jam shot right here. Little weak fly ball, ties his hands up. That's Jared Washburn when he's on. He's a high fastball pitcher. He goes north and south extremely well. Here's what happened to the Yankees.
Taking off to New York, yes.
Well, this is Matt Suey. He kind of had the right angle, and then he slowed up and went back after it again. That will go as a big error right there on a ball hit by Michael Young, and Texas Rangers go on to take the lead and give the Yankees in trouble again.
Yeah, that gets ugly as the two-run score. And, of course, the Yankees 9-12 since that great start of 18-3. Shall we take off to Detroit?
Well, we should. Got to be Brett Boone.
This is pretty much how he started the day.
That was not a home run a year ago. They brought those fences in from left field.
Yeah, Brett's pretty happy about that.
And that works for the Mariners, but not for the Tigers so far.
That's his eighth home run of the year. He hit another one, of course. Let's see. I'm going to go adding one here. Forgive me, Trot Nixon. 8-9, yes? Success. So he gets two home runs in this game. The Mariners win 6-3. Let's check out the AL East. And, Boston, with that opportunity day, make up some ground. I know it's early, but still.
Well, bullpen by committee, that wasn't really the issue today. The big home run by Gloss got him back in the game. A couple of mental miscues by the Red Sox, but the Yankees the same thing. So they remain one game back. And don't forget about the Blue Jays. I don't think they're going to win this thing, but they got some good young players in there. Vernon Wells, one of the RBI leaders in Major League Baseball. They got Hinsky. They're doing a nice job being competitive this year. And even Tampa Bay, 9.5 out. How about that under Lou Piniella? They got 17 wins already.
The AL West, obviously one of the toughest divisions in baseball, watching Seattle, Oakland, and Anaheim beat each other up, and let's not count out Texas either.
Well, what I like about Seattle is they re-signed their own free agents. They didn't go outside too much except for bench strength, but they re-signed Jamie Mori, who pitched today, pitched well. Edgar Martinez is healthy. Oakland's got those three great starters we know about. The Angels hovering right there about where they were a year ago. Don't worry about them. And you mentioned Texas, Junior. Great offensive ball club. Hank Blaylock leading the American League and overall in Major League Baseball in batting.
All right, a game you just saw. This kind of stuff's been going on a lot.
Arguing
ever since the Cubs and the Cardinals get together here the past week.
You're right. Over a high pitch call earlier, Tony thought it was a ball. It would cost him. Pujols would tie the game up, however, off of Mark Pryor, who threw extremely well. And, of course, the bullpen for the Cardinals has been the problem this year. 2-10, now 2-11. Looks like in one-run ball games. Just not getting it done out of that pen. Steve Kline giving it up to Mark Bellhorn, who hit 27 a year ago. It's only number two so far this year. But another one-run victory for the Cubs, a one-run loss for the St. Louis Cardinals.
Tony La Russa not around to see that one. He was tossed for the third time this season. And, coincidentally, it happened last Saturday versus the Cubs. So don't try to tell me that rivalry has gotten any softer.
No, you know, and that was a high pitch to Renteria, but it's a high strike that the umpires are calling these days. It was a strike. It made the count 3-2 instead of ball, four bases loaded. Next pitch, he gets a strike, him out, throw him out, double play. It knocked him out of the inning.
And as we've said a couple times here today, for the longest time, the Cubs were really just the butt of so many jokes. Nobody is laughing now. Dusty Baker turning him around. Next week, Fox Saturday Baseball returns with a showdown between old rivals and playoff contenders. It all begins next week at 1 p.m. Eastern and Pacific here on Fox. Thanks for being a part of our opening day. For Kevin Kennedy, I'm Jeannie Zlasko. We'll see you next week.
This has been a presentation of Fox Sports.
Hurry, there's still time to get the best values in America from Dodge. Take our best products like Dodge Caravan, the best-selling minivan ever, with available power sliding doors and power rear hatch. Plus our best warranty, Dodge's fully transferable 770 powertrain limited warranty. Plus our best deals, like up to a $3,500 cash allowance. Or 0% financing for 60 months. Add it all up, it equals the best values in America. See your Dodge dealer or visit Dodge.com.
Wow, these zesty White Castle jalapeno cheeseburgers are great.
Yeah.
I wonder what the world would be like if there were no jalapeno cheeseburgers. Wow, these regular White Castle hamburgers are great.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're some of ours. Try a tasty jalapeno cheeseburger today. It might change your life. White Castle, what you crave.
Dr. Schultz?
It's me. I sold my dental practice to become a flight attendant.
But you hate to travel.
Yeah, but I was paying for this national plan my wireless company sold me, and now I actually get to use it. Peanuts?
At U.S. Cellular, great wireless service starts with award-winning customer service.
So they'll make sure you get the plan that fits your needs.
U.S. Cellular, we connect with you. Now get 900 anytime minutes plus on